Welcome to another episode of Bobcat Breakdown, presented by the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network. I'm your host, Zach Daly, and I'm joined by Nick Dench, Andrew Badillo, and Darnell Raglin. On tonight's episode of Bobcat Breakdown, we'll discuss the real identity of the field hockey team. How long can the women's soccer team stay on top of the MAC standings? And will anyone else other than Simon Heim or Marshall Baker score for the men's soccer team? We'll also preview the women's ice hockey season and the entire ECAC. Gentlemen, let's break down the Bobcats. The men's soccer team picked up their first ever win against Yale this past weekend by a final score of 1-0. Borja Angoita picked up his third shutout of the season, and Simon Tyne picked up his team-leading fifth goal. But other than Marshall Baker, no one else has scored for the Bobcats. How big of a concern should this be for the squad? Darnell, we'll start with you.
It's hard to say. It's really tough this season. There's still 12 games left, but just going off of that, the team has scored 7 goals and 5 with Hine and 2 in Baker. But they need to really work on scoring more. I would say if they get more ball movement going and just keep attacking, maybe someone like an upperclassman can step up in Ola Ogunjobi. So I say definitely somebody will score eventually.
So Andrew, how big of a concern is this to you for the men's soccer team?
I feel like it's a big concern, quite honestly. I really don't see any other players stepping up at this point into the season. You know, heading into conference play, it is a big concern. Hind and Baker have been the only two players who have actually scored goals. You got James Doig, Justin Ward, and Rafael Carvalho, who have shown signs of getting involved in the offense but haven't really finished. And, you know, I feel at this point they need to figure it out. Or heading into conference play, it could be a real, you know, it could be a real struggle for the Bobcats.
Yeah, Nick, we've seen players like Carvalho, Ogunjobi come close, but they haven't been able to get that first goal of the season yet. What do you think about this team's lack of goal scorers?
It's a little bit of a concern. That is why they're at such a poor record right now, 2-3-3 on the season. But you got to like how some of the freshmen, Carvalho and Doig specifically, have really sparked the team in other ways. They're keeping the scoring against them down, which is always a positive. So once they start finding a scoring stride, they should be a little better off in the season, but it's just a matter of who's going to get that goal, when are they going to get it, and how quickly can they get it into conference play, because if they can't score in conference play, come playoff time, they're going to have a much more difficult time playing a worse team in the conference.
Yeah, this offense does seem to be gelling. We have seen flashes of brilliance from players other than Marshall Baker and Simon Hine, but it just seems like the final touch isn't there yet. Who do you think is going to be the player that, you know, is going to be able to put this Bobcats offense over the top?
Other than Marshall Baker?
Other than those two, yeah.
Ola Ogunjobi, I feel like he has the best chance of doing that. He's an upperclassman. He's a veteran. So he's a really good player to look at.
Now, Nick, I want to go to you to follow up on that, because you've watched this team for 3 years. You've watched Ogunjobi for the past. Do you think it's him, or do you think it's going to be somebody else?
I think it could be Ogunjobi. He is that different change of pace. He's not as fast as the rest of the Bobcats team, but he's much stronger on the ball. He's much stronger on the balls in the air, which is a positive thing for this team, so he can use his strength. I don't think it will be him who scores the first one. I think it's either going to be Carvalho, Doig, or Ryan Scheiderman, who we haven't mentioned yet. He's looked really good when he's on the field. He's strong. He's usually the first or second forward off the bench. So he's a guy who gets a lot more playing time than people may think if they don't watch the games. But Scheiderman, even Ward, they have good shots. It's just a matter of putting it past the defenders and keeping it low enough under that 8-foot crossbar.
Andrew?
I really like Justin Ward. I feel like there were a few games going against Holy Cross. He had two excellent opportunities to score. He had one nullified. He had one goal. He had one goaling opportunity nullified by offsides, and he had another great opportunity. The goalie made an incredible save. But I think, you know, Ward. It could be any of them. Ward, Carvalho, Ogunjobi, Scheiderman. It could be really any. But at the same time, the team has struggled all year. Heading into conference play, they need to figure it out right now.
Now, how long do you think that the men's soccer team can continue to rely on that back line and Angoita before it gets them, especially moving forward to conference play? Nick?
I don't think they can rely on them too much longer. They're going to have to start finding somebody outside of of Baker and of Hind. They're going to need some sort of spark. You've got to hope, if you're the Bobcats, that you get somebody outside of those two to score against Iona this weekend. That's going to be a huge thing. If you can get one of them, if you can get somebody to score outside of that right away in conference play, it's going to be a huge confidence boost for this whole team. And, I mean, even somebody from the back could get it in. Toby Ash has really looked good coming forward on those corner kicks. It's just a matter of somebody finding a scoring touch, even if it's just for one goal to pump the team up a little bit.
Andrew?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like the back line could support a little bit more. Obviously, they've been struggling all year, the offense with Baker and Hind only having the only goals. But, I mean, anybody, like Toby Esch looking good off those corner kicks, stepping up, any extra the midfielders getting involved, really, they just, it's by scoring by committee. They need, everyone needs to get involved in order for them to score, as it's been a struggle all year.
All right, Dom now, bring us home on men's soccer.
Yeah, definitely. Just going off what both of them said, like, somebody needs to score. Definitely, somebody needs to just come up and step up, whoever it can be. James Doig, it has to be somebody other than Masha Baker and Hind to definitely get this soccer team back on track.
All right, well, changing our focus from the men's team to the women's soccer team, Coach Dave Clark and his squad have yet to lose a game in MAC play and currently sit in first place with 7 points. And for a team that didn't see much offense in non-conference play, they have scored 6 goals in their last 3 games. Not only that, they have had 5 different goal scorers on those 6 goals. So, Dench, we'll start with you on this one. How long can the women's team stay at the top of the MAC standings?
I'd actually be a little surprised if it was more than 2 weeks. This is a team who you mentioned really hasn't scored that much outside of conference play, but you look at the teams they played in conference play, and that's the bottom half of the conference. Once they start playing teams like Monmouth and Manhattan, it's going to be a much more difficult time for them to stay with the competition, with the limited scoring they've had. They've had 8 goals in 8 games. So that's something you've got to look at. And 6 of them, yes, in conference play. One of them was on a penalty kick. That was, I guess you could say, a generous call. So you got to think that they have to step it up another level if they want to stay up there.
Andrew?
Totally agree with you, Nick. I mean, the team, Anya McKeever and Jessica Fontaine, have scored 2 goals each. They did play Ryder and Sienna. They're sort of the middle of the pack of the MAC. I wouldn't overlook that as, hey, they started to score and Quinnipiac is, you know, surprising people. They were projected 8th in the preseason MAC. I don't think they'll last very long. They have yet to play Fairfield or Monmouth, who are two of the better teams in the MAC. I mean, Natalia Grotsky did have a really good weekend. She won MAC Defensive Player of the Week. So, I mean, I wouldn't get too in front of ourselves. I wouldn't get too, you know, wow, Quinnipiac, they've won. They're already on top of the MAC. I wouldn't get too ahead of ourselves just yet.
Darnell?
I don't feel like it would last that much. They really have been playing teams that haven't been that great. They played against an 0-2 St. Peter's team, and they played against a Ryder team that hasn't really beat any team in the MAC. And so they'll probably be tested more when they play teams like Fairfield. So once they play them, I feel like it won't last.
Nick, I say you wanted to rebuttal there, but also Andrew touched on Grotsky a little bit, and that's something we are a little critical of in the beginning of the season. How do you think she's come along?
Yeah, that's actually what I was going to talk about. She's definitely improved since the beginning of the season. She had a couple huge saves against Sienna, one on the penalty kick, which is skill enough as it is just saving a penalty kick. But once you get it, it's also luck. She guessed right, and that's huge for her confidence. And then she had a huge diving save on a huge left-footed strike. So she is really working on that reaction time in practice, and it's improving her game, and it's making the Bobcats a little bit stronger. It's just her distribution that she needs to work on now.
Darnell, anything else?
I definitely agree with Nick all the way with that, definitely.
All right, well, we're going to take a quick break here on Bobcat Breakdown, but when we come back, we'll talk field hockey. You're watching Bobcat Breakdown, presented by the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network. Welcome back to Bobcat Breakdown. The field hockey team traveled to Virginia this past weekend, where their 4-game winning streak came to an end with a 7-0 loss to Old Dominion. Prior to the loss, Quinnipiac outscored their opponent 17-2 and were led by the play of goalie Megan Conaboy. The question I'm posing to you guys is, what team are we most likely to see as we roll into conference play? The team that lost 7-0 to Old Dominion, or the team that outscored their previous 4 opponents 7-2? Darnell, we'll start with you.
I would definitely say the team that's been on the homestand. They've been really consistent before even playing Old Dominion, and they've been playing an Old Dominion team that is actually top 25 in the country, so it's a really tough team to play. And in the MAC conference, no one's on that level of Old Dominion's kind of play, so The Bobcats has been doing a really good job playing against teams that are in the MAC, which are not even on Old Dominion's level, so I wouldn't be concerned about them at all.
Andrew?
I totally agree with you, Darnell. You go back earlier into the season when they played Boston College, a team that's even in the top 10 in the nation, and they made it really close against them. They almost pulled out that game. I wouldn't be too concerned about the Old Dominion game. I mean, 7-0, it is an alarming score. Conaboy was playing really well in the previous games, holding teams to one goal, shutting some teams out, making some incredible saves. I wouldn't get too worried. I see it more as a game where they were a little tired and a little off their game rather than, wow, this team just out of nowhere started to struggle. So I wouldn't be too worried.
And how, Nick, I know you're one of the field hockey aficionados for the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network, so I'll ask you, they looked really good in those previous four games, but then they had to fly down to Virginia. They spent the night to try and recover. But do you think the travel played into their loss at all?
I'm not going to make excuses for this team. That was an atrocious game. That was bad. They gave up 6 goals in the second half. They're a first-half team. This is a team that has played very well in the first half this year, and they did. They gave up 1 goal to a very good Old Dominion team. They come out in the second half, and they give up 6 goals to an Old Dominion team, and they haven't scored in the second half much at all this year. This is a team who, in years past, we've seen them. They're much better in the second half. They're going to need to figure out how to maybe balance that out and leave some of the energy for the second half, or else they're going to be in trouble in the MAC. They're playing teams against, like, Ryder. You're going to struggle, especially when you have to go to Ryder, not once, but presumably twice, is one of the best teams in the MAC. So if they have to play Ryder at Ryder a second time, they are going to have to figure it out for that second half.
Well, prior to that 4-game winning streak, the Bobcats were scoring a lot in the second half. They transferred all their energy, it appears, over to the first half. For those 4 games. But how do you think this team's going to balance their attack out? Do they just have to work on... What do you guys think? I'm not that big of a field hockey expert.
I would definitely say that just keep on with the ball movement and just play against... just play really hard. I mean, they've been doing really great. Like Nick said, in the first half, they're a first-half team, so if they can just keep playing a dominant in the first half and keep on the defensive end in the second half, they should be fine.
Yeah, definitely. Strategy that Coach Becca Main pointed out to me after the Vermont Catamounts game was that they wanted to keep their passes really short and concise. You know, one pass, one touch, pass to the next player, keeping the defense off balance. I think that's a really good strategy to play as you head into the MAC and also to recover from their big loss against Old Dominion. Kind of get back down to the basics and find what they were doing right against Vermont, against St. Joseph's.
Yeah, I think defense is going to be a huge part because they've played strong defense for the most part. But especially in the second half, they play that strong defense, and they just have a little bit of issues getting the ball past midfield and really working on a counterattack. I think that's the most important thing for them in the second half, just getting onto that counterattack and pushing it forward to your star forwards, Kristen Engelke, Jess Roosen, Danielle Allen, Savannah Riley's been really good this year. Just start getting it up to them in the second half and play ball control up in the front half.
Well, Nick, you led perfectly right into my second question for the field hockey team. We know these forwards can score, but which forward do you guys think is going to finish the season with more goals? Jess Roosen, Danielle Allen, or Kristen Engelke? Darnell?
I would definitely say Jess Roosen. She seems like the more consistent out of the three, just with like the season so far. She's 3 away from tying the Quinnipiac Bobcats scoring record, and she has 6 goals this season, so she's really been dominant. With Danielle Allen, she had 3 goals in last game, so she kind of just jumped up there. But out of those three, I would say Jess Roosen.
Andrew.
Darnell, you stole my answer there. Jess Roosen, I feel like that's the consensus. Jess Roosen, she's 3 away from tying. It's on her mind, definitely. But I feel once she gets those 3 goals off her chest, it's going to be rapid fire. She's going to be scoring goal after goal after goal. She's a proven goal scorer. Same with Engelke, I think. But I feel Jess Roosen, really, it's her year. After she is predicted to break the record, I feel that the goals will start coming more often.
Now, one thing we've seen out of Jess Roosen is she scores in bunches. And she had a little bit of a drought in that homestand, so... Nick, who do you think is going to score the most?
I'm playing devil's advocate. I would love to agree with Jess Roosen, but yes, she plays in bunches. She expressed her concern after, I believe it was the St. Joe's game, that she really didn't know why she wasn't scoring, and that's an issue. She needs to start figuring that out. Kristen Engelke will lead this team in goal scoring this year. She has really come back for her graduate year, with an extra step on everybody. She's fast. She's better with the stick. She's finding goal-scoring opportunities, and she's really just putting everything home when she needs to. She's getting 2 goals a game when she needs to. She's in the right position. She's finding her teammates. She has really impressed me coming back for her graduate year this year.
Now, Nick said that whenever Kristen Engelke gets a scoring opportunity, she usually converts. But the team most likely is going to go to Jess Roosen when they need a scoring opportunity. Now, Andrew and Darnell, you guys said you think Jess Roosen is going to lead the team in goals this year. Do you think her getting more opportunities is going to play to that, even though she can't convert as much as Kristen Engelke does?
I would definitely say the opportunities as more, too. If she gets more of those opportunities, she can do it. Where I do see Kristen Engelke maybe getting that, too, because she's really quick and she's come off a great graduate year so far. And she's just really been dominant. And Danielle Allen, she's really just kind of came up there from playing against Holy Cross with those 3 goals. But yeah, Jess Roosen can get a lot of opportunities. I still think Jess Roosen can be the leading scorer.
Andrew?
Yeah, Roosen and Engelke. They both have had similar opportunities as far as shots on shots go, and goals similar. I think Roosen has five, and Engelke has 6. And so I feel that, you know, it's just going to be, I think it's going to come down to Roosen in the end. I do think, you know, as we said earlier, she does score in bunches, but I think after she gets the record, the goals will start coming. Not to say that Engelke will stop scoring, but I think since the opportunities mostly go to Roosen, I think she will take the leading goal total for the team this year.
All right, well, it'll be interesting to watch down the stretch. We're going to step aside for a minute, but when we come back, we'll talk women's ice hockey and preview the ECAC. Stay with us. Welcome back to Bobcat Breakdown. The women's ice hockey season starts this weekend. The Bobcats start their season on the road as they travel to St. Cloud State for 2 games. Now, guys, how do you see the ECAC shaping up this year? Andrew, who do you have as your top team and why?
My top team is going to be Clarkson University this year. They're returning a lot of the players they had last year. We're going to start with Jamie Lee Rattray, the senior forward. She was 14th in D1 scoring last year, had 22 goals, 30 assists, 52 points. She's a big power forward. She's only getting better. Also, you have sophomore defenseman Erin Ambrose, who is an absolute force. They played RIT over the weekend in their first game of the season. 3 goals and 2 assists for a defenseman. That's incredible. I know RIT isn't the best team, but it's a defenseman scoring 3 goals, 5 points. That's really impressive. And lastly, their goalie, Erica Howe, she's returning for her senior year, 1.73 goals against average, 27-10 record last year. This team is stacked. I feel like they're just going to take the ECAC by the throat this year, and it's going to be really tough for teams like Cornell, Quinnipiac, and Harvard to really compete.
Now, Darnell, do you also have Clarkson at number one?
I don't. I have Cornell, and I'm just sticking with this season from last season. Cornell's been really dominant last season, and I don't see them actually going down at all. Cornell, they only lost 3 seniors in Lauren Rusu and Laura Fertino and Anne Moley. So they're really good at just being dominant, too. And they only lost 3 seniors, and they had 3 new seniors that have really been good, too. So I don't see them being a lower team than number one this season.
Nick, who do you have at number one?
I got Clarkson. Clarkson's such a strong team. As Andrew mentioned, they scored 12 goals against RIT, 10 different goal scorers. And the other one, obviously, Erin Ambrose, who had 3 goals. That's insane. Ambrose, 36 points as a freshman defender last year. So you got to think she's going to keep improving, especially with some of the players in the league going to their national teams, Canada, United States, even Sweden with Eric Uden Johansson for the Bobcats. But this is a very strong team. Erica Howe is huge back in net. She's one of the best ECAC goalies the past couple of years. And don't forget their captain, Carly Mercer. She is a great leader for that team. She also knows how to put the puck in the net. And then you have her sister who's coming in also, who scored a goal. So this is a very balanced team. They know how to score and they know how to defend. It's going to be a very tough team to beat this year.
All right, Darnell, where do you have Clarkson?
Clarkson, I have number 2. They should make some noise this season. They have Mercer and Rattray, which are really good on the offensive end. So they're really doing good with that. So on the defensive end, they have two great goalies, too. So they have a really balanced attack with the offensive and the defensive end, too. But I still have them at number 2 because I feel Cornell is just a little bit more stronger.
Andrew, where do you have Cornell?
I have Cornell too. I disagree totally with Darnell as the number one. I don't see how they can overcome Clarkson. They lost their best. It's kind of up in the air. Their best player, Breanne Jenner, she's in camp for the national team, and nobody really knows if she's going to be in camp playing for Cornell. It's up in the air at this point, which is why I put them at two. Even you could put them at three, Harvard and Quinnipiac. I kind of have battling for the 3-4 position. But I totally see Clarkson as the one, Cornell as a risky two, Quinnipiac and Harvard 3 and 4.
And Nick, where do you have Cornell?
I have Cornell as a hard two. Cornell, obviously, losing those three seniors, and Breanne Jenner, who is just a force up front. She had 70 points last year for Cornell, so I can't see her not making Team Canada. She's that good. But you can't leave out Lauren Slobodnik in net. She, like Erica Howe, probably the two elite ECAC goaltenders the last couple of years, and they are just so good back there. Slobodnik is very good positioning. She's one of the taller goalies, so she can cover the top of the net better. And then you also have their captain, Jillian Saulnier. She's huge back. She's huge for that team.
State to try and get out early here on the Bobcats. Try to get a quick one here maybe and try to tie this weekend up and head home with the tie.
Penn State's going to have to get out to an early start. Up until the past weekend, they hadn't scored 3-plus goals in back-to-back games since January 4th and 5th of last year, so getting on the board early is going to be huge for them, because this Bobcats team can score, and they have two very good scoring lines, and that third line even yesterday looked really good scoring, so it's going to be tough if the Penn State can't get out early.
All right, faceoff will be won by Penn State. Pardoski goes for the early dump and clear in. Layden's out to slow it down. Baumgart trying to play it up for Brackett. Gets tied up in the near corner. He's trying to get a centering feed there. It was gross. A couple players now meet up with it. And taking it is Fritz Ward. Could be a quick three on two for the Bobcats if they hurry. Fritz Ward opts to just skate it into the zone. Shot off the skate of Pardoski. Fritz Ward trying to get her own rebound. Trying to be cleared out by Wilkie. Eventually Pardoski will take it. Try to play it up far side. Emma Woods, though, takes it fresh off the bench. And keeps it into the zone. Babstock takes it, trying to get into the slot. Nice defensive play by Wilkie, trying to be chipped out of the zone. West keeps for Quinnipiac. Pardoski loses an edge, and Woods trying to skate right in there and take it. Nice job by Nielsen to come to her aid. All the way around, it is kept into the zone by Tamberg, all the way back in. Wilkie in the near corner, trying to play it out, taken by Collin. This one gets popped up high in the air. Collin trying to get the centering feed, but the puck was just deflected. West can't keep this one into the zone. Brought out for Connery. Tamberg trying to play it back to Connery in front of the Bobcats bench. And Connery is just going to clear this one down. Getting there first for Penn State is Bateman. This one up high. Glove down by Wignall. Back into the zone for the Nittany Lions. Early goings on here. 18:30 left to go in the first period. Still no score. It's going to be a 2-on-1 now for Penn State, though. Here's Bowman into the zone. Bowman shoots. Saved by Layden. Rebound out in front. Nobody was there to put it home, though. Bateman just flings this one towards the net. Off the skate there of Greco. Megan Turner into the zone. Out to slow it down is Whitlinger. A couple players bump in behind the goal. And eventually Penn State will clear it. Fritz Ward trying to play it. Nice job there by Peterson to knock it down. All the way deep down to the Bobcat zone. And we've got our first whistle of the afternoon. Icing against Penn State with 17:59 left to go in the first period.
Good job by Shelby Wignall on that 2-on-1 advantage for Penn State. She saw the opportunity to take away the passing lane and took away a good scoring opportunity, making an odd angle shot for Penn State.
Faceoff won by the Bobcats. Chance there for Roosler at the point. Opted to go for the pass. Woods now in the near corner. Couple players meeting up. Eventually it's worked up to Hohenschel. Hohenschel trying to get around the defensive bomb guard. This one's cleared back down, and it is another icing against Penn State. So going to have a couple of tired legs there on the side of things for the Nittany Lions. Bobcats going to look to capitalize.
Long shift for this line for Penn State as they can't seem to get their line out without the icing, so another line change for the Bobcats. Fresh legs.
Faceoff won by Quinnipiac. Brown trying to keep it in. D'Arcangelo all the way around. Far side for Tamberg. Tamberg trying to get a centering feed for Brown. Her shot gets saved there by Whitlinger. No Bobcats on the doorstep to try to put home the rebound. Now it's D'Arcangelo. Eventually loses it off her stick. Nice job by Bowman to protect it. Try to work it all the way around. Getting there first was Yonke. Nice keep though by Quinnipiac. D'Arcangelo still has it. D'Arcangelo trying to get the pass in the slot. Still trying to get it out. Unable to was Yonke. Quinnipiac still able to keep it in. Eventually it is worked out. Hohenschel has it. She's going to fire it down. Penn State finally able to get the change. Tamberg meets up along the boards behind Layden. Puck trickles out in front, but it's taken by Turner. Turner trying to work it up to Borgfeld. Can't corral that hard pass eventually, but she does take it in the neutral zone, trying to work it into the zone for Penn State. This one shot into the zone on goal, gloved down by Rittlinger. And she's going to opt to hold with 16:36 left to go in the first period. Still no score.
Penn State finally getting that line change, and they came out with a lot of speed. They were anxious to get on the ice, and they pressured the Bobcats on that forecheck, unable to do anything with it.
Bobcats win the faceoff yet again. Chance by Woods, opting to go off the boards behind. Back to the point for Greco, across for Wignall. Wignall, wrist shot, that gets deflected, goes behind the goal. Connery centering feed, nobody there on the doorstep. Connery still has it, trying to work it out in front. Into the slot, he gets taken down, and puck trickles to the far side. Nice pinch there by Wignall. Penn State will take this one. Seward trying to get it all the way around. Nice job by Connery. Trying to keep it. This one gets poked off her stick, though, and just chipped into the zone further by Woods. Babstock now in there, trying to protect it. Babstock, nice job there. Eventually it comes to the stick of a Nittany Lion, and Ryo is going to get it far side, chip it out. Nice job there by Wignall to keep it into the zone, though. She gloved it down. Brown coming her aid now as it's 3-on-1 in favor of Penn State. Battling along the boards. Puck still not being able to get loose. Nice job by Wignall to keep it into the zone. Players still met up along the boards. And Penn State will escape with it. Work it all the way around the boards. Pinched by Greco, and it can't be held in the zone. D'Arcangelo playing it back for Wignall. Wignall circles to look at her options. She goes back for Greco. Greco trying to pass it up here for Colin. Colin into the zone. She has fresh legs. Colin, nice job here. Her shot. That just goes through the crease. And Colin gets her own rebound far side. Try to work it back in deep. 15-11 left to go in the first period. Team still looking for the first goal of the afternoon. Fritz Ward couldn't keep this one down. No icing, though, as it touched Fritz Ward's stick. Baumgard collects behind Layden. Puts the brakes on, opts to go back to Roessler. Roessler trying to get a pass there. Fritz Ward, she couldn't connect. It's now a foot race to get to it, but it will be icing against the Bobcats. First for them of the afternoon.
Bobcats trying to get on that stretch pass, find Fritz Ward, who was streaking up the middle of the ice. Little too high of a saucer pass from Roessler. Fritz Ward's not fast enough to get to the faceoff dots. Neither team able to capitalize on these icings so far.
Faceoff to the right of Layden. Fritz Ward in against there with Nielsen. Quick shot here. Just gets deflected wide for Penn State. Another shot here. Goes off the stick of Layden out in front. Roessler now with Nielsen into the corner. Nice job by Nielsen to get away. Eventually passes it back to Yoxheimer. Centering feeder for Gross. She couldn't get a stick on it. Nice clear there by the Bobcats. And looking to break out with it is Roessler. Roessler opts to go for the dump in. Bobcats go for the full line change. Pass gets deflected off the stick of Tamberg. She plays it back for West at the Bobcat blue line. West going off the boards for Babstock. She couldn't get a stick on it. Now it's Borgfeld. Borgfeld gets that one poked away. Kept at the blue line by Tamberg. Wrist shot there. Blocked away by Rittlinger. Here's Babstock. Back to the blue line for Tamberg. Tamberg slap shot gets deflected high by Yoxheimer off the glass. Penn State now just trying to get it out. Nice job there by West to keep it in. Babstock trying to keep it in. Eventually it'll be worked up to Yoxheimer. She's going to flying this one out of the zone. Tambo couldn't corral it. So it's West up for Babstock. And she's just going to skyhook this one in the zone for the line change. 13:36 left to go in the first period. Still no score. Penn State having some trouble getting out of their own zone. Welch couldn't get that one around Colin. Yeah, eventually she does work it up into the Bobcat zone. Layden out all the way around the boards for Brown. Tough pass there off the boards, eventually taking it as Wignall. Wignall playing it up for Colin into the zone. Colin, her shot gets deflected. Tricky shot there. Good save by Rittlinger. D'Arcangelo couldn't get the rebound. Penn State clears this down the length of the ice. Greco is in a foot race here, trying to race down and get it before Rasmussen. Indeed she does. It will be icing against Penn State.
And the Bobcats once again putting a lot of pressure on the forecheck. unable to capitalize on these errant passes from Penn State so far, and they have to capitalize on one of these icings. Penn State seems to be opting for icing more than anything to clear the puck out of the zone.
Faceoff won by the Bobcats. Fritz Ward trying to work it around for Borgfeld. Her and Rasmussen meet far side. Turner trying to come to the aid there of her Bobcat forward. Borgfeld works it back to the point. Roosler across for Baumgart. Baumgart takes the shot wide. And collecting with it now for Penn State's Yonke, but the Bobcats still have it. Turner chipping it around the boards for Fritz Ward. Slows the play down, trying to get it back to Turner. Fritz Ward had some trouble with it in her skates. Turner now putting her stick in there, trying to get it. Turner, nice protection of the puck. Eventually she gets knocked off, though. And Fritz Ward takes down her player. Baumgart playing it up here quick for Fritz Ward. Just clears it into the zone on goal. Seward trying to get it around the boards, trying to play it up for Weaver. Shot there from the point by West, trying to connect with Connery in the slot for the deflection, just goes wide. Babstock trying to get that one, and Penn State will get it out, though. West has it, trying to play it up. She gets entangled with a couple of Nittany Lions in front of her bench. Nicole Brown trying to come to her aid. Nice job there, defensive play by Babstock to get it off the stick of Hohenschel. Babstock trying to play it off of Brown. She just goes for the clear into the zone. Ryle in there with Woods. Woods does have it, trying to work it out to the front. Gets deflected off the backboards. Bobcat still keep it into the zone. Shot here on goal. Nice pass save. Another shot there by Brown. And Whitlinger is there to close it. But Brown had a wide open net, but a good pad save there by Whitlinger to keep this a scoreless game.
Dark Angelo taking a shot with a purpose there, knowing that she's probably not going to score on that. Throws it low. Blocker side gets a great rebound for Nicole Brown. Just stoned by Whitlinger, who got across her crease very quickly.
Bobcats trying to keep this in. It trickles out. Collected by Shelby Wignall. Hit Brown in front of the penalty boxes. So not the alluded effect there to get him deep into the zone. But now here's Lorenzi's shot into the pads of Layden. Popped up into her glove. She's going to hold with 11:16 left to go in the first period.
First or second, good, clean, clear for Penn State. They bring it right up the side, knowing that they're having trouble getting the puck out of their zone, taking a quick shot to make sure it stays in their offensive zone for a little while.
Faceoff won by Penn State. Quick shot there, right on the doorstep. Was gross, but she couldn't get the deflection. Here's Baumgart. Baumgart had trouble getting that one on her stick. Centering feeder for Penn State goes high off the back of the net, right in front of Layden. Penn State still trying to keep the pressure on. Shot there, gets deflected. Wilkie. Baumgart trying to play it up for Brackett. Wilkie keeps it. Play it off the skate there for Nielsen. Wilkie is going to take this one, ring it all the way around the boards. It's going to go far side for Roosler, trying to play it up for Babstock. Nice job there to knock it down in front of her own bench was Bateman. And this one back into the Bobcat zone. Baumgart is there. Playing it across for Roosler. Roosler trying to get it up here for Fritz Ward. Fritz Ward trying to connect with Brackett. And Bobcats go for the full five line change. Getting in there first for Penn State's Yonke. Yonke playing it up for Lorenzi. Eventually touching with the pass there to Sorcy. But the Bobcats will look to break out. Here's Babstock with the steal. Babstock hooked a couple of times. And that indeed will bring power play to the Bobcats. Babstock was hooked around the hands. And heading to the box indeed is just a Sorcy.
Babstock always a scoring threat for the Bobcats. All-time leading scorer now with 156 career points. So she's really a threat. She's on the minds of these Nittany Lions. And she's drawing a penalty there, getting the Bobcats the first power play of the day.
The Bobcats to the power play, first of the afternoon, 10:05 left to go in the first period. Couple of players meet up on the boards. Babstock escapes with it. Centering feeder for Baumgart. She shoots. Deflected there off the skate of Peterson. Bobcats still trying to keep the attack going. Connery kicks it to the back for Babstock. Trying to go all the way around. Baumgart gets there first. She's just going to try to shoot this in, keep it into the zone, but nice job there by the Penn State penalty kill to get it out. Roosler collects at her own blue line. Into the neutral zone, trying to play it up. Babstock is there, has to work her way around the linesman. Babstock getting it to Connery. Here for Turner, fresh off the bench. Her shot goes off defender. Now another shot, that one goes up high. And there will be a whistle as it was played with the high stick of one of the Penn State players, so that'll keep the faceoff in the zone.
Referee had his hands up there for a while, waiting to see whether Babstock or a Penn State player was going to get a hand, get their stick on that. Penn State had three or four people struggling to get their stick on that puck.
Faceoff won by the Bobcats. Tamberg at the blue line, trying to go here for Brown, far side. Back to Tamberg, looking at her options. Still walking along the blue line. Turner has that one go off her left skate, but she's able to keep it in. Back to the blue line for Tamberg. Tamberg, wrist shot there. Save by Whitlinger.
The thing that the Bobcats tried to do a lot yesterday, and it seems like they're trying to do a lot again today, is take shots from further back and try to get some tips on it. They don't have a lot of pure scoring on the ice at all times, so when they don't, they're throwing the puck on net and hoping somebody can tip it past the goaltender.
Quick puck drop there on the faceoff, won by the Bobcats. Baumgart trying to get it back for Woods. Shot there, gets on. Another shot here by Baumgart. She shoots. Whitlinger doesn't know where it is. But nice job there by Connery to stretch out and keep it in. 40 left to go on the power play to the Bobcats. Connery across here for Woods. Her shot goes wide. Connery still on the attack. In the far corner. Check to the boards there by Podolski. Babsock now comes to her aid. Babsock works it back to the blue line for Baumgart. Fakes the shot. Going eventually to Roessler. Roessler, wrist shot there. Saved by Whitlinger. Babsock jabbing away at it on the doorstep. But Whitlinger coming up big here so far in the afternoon for Penn State.
Babsock always in front of the net on the power play. She's very good at picking up those rebounds and jabbing at the goalie if she does catch it cleanly. So getting underneath the skin of these Penn State players early.
8:32 left to go in the first period. 22 left to go on the power play for the Bobcats. Fritz Ward in for the faceoff. Got tangled up there in the skates of the linesman, and Penn State's able to clear it down the length of the ice. West for the Bobcats slows it down. Trying to break out now. Maybe a last rush opportunity here for Quinnipiac on the power play. D'Arcangelo has it, using her long reach to try to keep it in. Fritz Ward doesn't know where it is. And it'll be flipped in on goal by the Bobcats. That'll do it with the man advantage. So Bobcats 0-1 on the afternoon. Here's Gross for Penn State. She can't connect there with Nielsen, but now she's in a foot race. She's trying to get it in. Can't get around West. Eventually getting there is Tamberg. Tamberg, nice job putting on the brakes, circling around with it. But Nielsen, nice job to keep it into the Bobcats zone. Puck trickles out in front. Shot here gets deflected off the Quinnipiac defense. Bateman trying to get there first. Eventually it's worked up to D'Arcangelo, who just clears it to the neutral zone. This one brought back into the zone by Seward. Layden's out to slow it down. Dropped off. D'Arcangelo has it now. Working it up here for Fritz Ward. Her backhander trying to get it deep into the zone. Bobcats go for the line change. Yoxheimer couldn't get a clean stick on that one. Trying to get there first is Bowman. She pins Wignall to the boards. Trying to come to aid now is Hohenschel. Centering feed here. Peterson couldn't get a clean stick on it. And Connery's going to break out now with Woods. Woods into the zone. Has Connery in the slot. Her shot saved there by Whitlinger. Babstock looking at her options. Going back in the near boards. Puck goes into the slot there. Backhanded by Woods. But again, another deflection shot from the defense of Penn State. Hohenschel, nice job to keep it, but nice job there to steal it away by Woods. Wignall's going to take it out of the Bobcat zone. Wignall, towards the end of her shift, gets taken down and to the boards in front of the penalty box. Now it's Peterson, far side for Penn State. Her shot gets deflected off of Greco. Roessler is out in the Bobcat zone. Her pass trying to connect with Babstock. Touch to nobody in particular, and that will be icing against the Bobcats with 6:25 left to go in the first period, still scoreless.
Bobcats with a strong power play. Penn State counters after that power play or penalty kill with a strong attack of their own, trying to get something going in the last 6.5 minutes of the period.
Quinnipiac wins the faceoff. It's Roessler. Circles around, looking for one of her forwards to pass to, trying to find up there with Fritz Ward, but was deflected by Welch. So no icing against the Bobcats. They're able to get the line change. Turner in behind, trying to ring it all the way around the boards. Held by Baumgart, trying to connect there with D'Arcangelo. She can't keep it in. Baumgart forced to play it in front of her bench. Tamberg slows it. D'Arcangelo, center ice. D'Arcangelo trying to get around the Penn State players. Too many to get through in front of the Penn State bench. Layden slows it down for Baumgart. Baumgart fires the pass up here for Brackett. Nice job there using her stick with Lorenzi to poke it away. This one trickles back into the Bobcat zone. Baumgart circles with it in front of Layden. And eventually decides to just skate it in on her own into the neutral zone. Back down. Brown is there trying to keep it into the Penn State zone. This one worked all the way around far side, trying to be pinned to the boards there. It was DeSourcy. Eventually taking his Babstock in the neutral zone up for Connery. Connery trying to get a couple moves there around the Penn State defense. It's Roessler knocking it down in the neutral zone. Roessler needs to watch there from the forecheck of Holdcroft. Woods has it for the Bobcats. She opts to go all the way around the boards. Far side, getting there first, though, is DeSourcy. She looks to clear. Nice job to hold it in by Fritz Ward. Back to the blue line for Roessler. She fakes the shot, trying to go across for Turner. Turner, back for Roessler. She has room to take the shot. She does. It's saved by Whitlinger. And she's going to cover that up with her glove with 4:43 left to go in the first period.
That play almost reminiscent of the goal that Morgan Fritz Ward scored yesterday. Shot from the point off the stick of Sid Roessler, and Fritz Ward getting a tip on it, just unable to beat the goaltender this time around. Yesterday, getting a good, solid tip on the puck and beating the goaltender.
Face-off won by Penn State. It was Nielsen against Turner. Wignall can't keep this one to the zone, so Greco coming from her corner, trying to get up to Turner, goes in between her legs. Nice job there by Greco to keep it out. Trying to play up with Fritz Ward. Ryle trying to play it. Nice job there by Wignall. Eventually it does get worked up. Fritz Ward has it, trying to get around the diving Penn State player. Now it's Borgfeldt. Borgfeldt here. Shot there. Oh, it's off the post from Fritz Ward. What a tic-tac-toe play between Borgfeldt, Brown, and Fritz Ward. But again, the Bobcats are held without the goal. This one held in the zone by West. Her shot goes right into the crest of Whitlinger. And she will hold with 4 minutes left to go in the first period. Easily best chance of the afternoon, Nick, for the Bobcats.
Oh, absolutely. Bobcats with a great tic-tac-toe play, getting all three forwards involved in the puck, finding Fritz Ward's stick. Either hit the post or a great outstretch save by Whitlinger to keep that puck out of the net.
Delayed offsides call here against the Bobcats. And going to bring the face-off in front of the penalty boxes. D'Arcangelo against Bowman. Face-off won by D'Arcangelo, trying to get it back for West. Her backhander trying to slide along the blue line for the Bobcats and find Tamberg. Tamberg trying to go back for West. In front of the Bobcats bench, he gets tangled up a little bit, but eventually Brown will clear it in. And the Bobcats will go for the line change. Peterson for Penn State gets stolen by Amanda Collin. Collin is trying to get this one back deep into the Nittany Lions end. Nice cycle here by the Bobcats. Collin, this one, trickles off her stick. D'Arcangelo trying to help her out, keep this in, and eventually pops up in the air and knocked down by Hohenschel. Hohenschel trying to cleave it. Nice job by Roessler to get it. Now it's Connery. Connery trying to get it. Nice job here. Woods, rolling puck she had to deal with. Hard pass there, goes off the skate of Hohenschel. Roessler is there, and now it's Woods getting it away from Peterson, breaking it back into the neutral zone for Connery. And Connery's going to clear this one down. Getting there first, though, would be Woods. Centering feed here. She had Babstock in the slot, but she couldn't get a full stop on it. Now it's Brown in the slot. And her shot just whiffed on it a bit. Back to the blue line for Wignall for Greco. Greco has it. She takes the shot. Deflected save by Whitlinger. Bobcats starting to put some pressure on here late in the period. Breaking out now is Bateman for Penn State, and she's just going to opt to clear this one down far corner. Wignall is there. She has to contend with the forecheck of Rasmussen. As Weaver trying to get that to the front. Wignall has it. Weak puck. Eventually finds Greco. Greco looking at her options. Trying to connect up with one of her Bobcats forwards. Fritz Ward's now on the forecheck. In there with Turner. This one trickling to the front. Nice job there by Bateman to corral it. Holdcroft clears it high off the glass. Tamberg gets there first. She has DeSourcy right with her in the Bobcats' end. Nice job there. Stutter step move by Tamberg. Tamberg still putting the Jets on in the neutral zone. Here's the Bobcats now in the zone. As it's Collins slowing it down. Could have had an option to shoot it. Trying to work it back to the blue line. Nice job there to keep it in by Fritz Ward. This one all the way around. Far side. Pardoski playing it out eventually. Lindsey West touches up for Quinnipiac. Roessler at the blue line, trying to cut through the neutral zone, touch up with D'Arcangelo. D'Arcangelo escapes with it. D'Arcangelo into the zone, shoots, and that gets deflected. Nice job there off the stick from Kelly Seward. Back to the blue line here for Baumgart. Baumgart, nice couple of moves there trying to get around, but great diving play there to knock it out by Holdcroft. 1:15 left to go in the first period. Still, teams are scoreless here in Hamden. Here's Baumgard after Connery met up with one of the Penn State players in the neutral zone, but circling around with it is Yoxheimer. Yoxheimer, nice job to cut through the neutral zone, but Quinnipiac defense is there to meet her. Now it's Babstock for the Bobcats. Into the zone, last minute play here in the first. Babstock, this one rolls off her stick. She's still able to get a shot off and a save by Whitlinger. Brown getting the cycle for Babstock. Back to Brown. Brown into the zone, shoots, and she gets her shot gets deflected right over. She had all time in the world to walk right in. Indeed, she did, but nice deflection play there by the Penn State defense. And a delayed offsides call against the Bobcats with 33 seconds left to go in the first period.
Something that Penn State's really shown that they've improved on overnight almost is getting in front of these shots and tipping. The Bobcats credited with 20 shots right now, probably could have 30 if there weren't so many blocked shots by Penn State.
As this slow shot, I should say slow opportunity from the neutral zone just trickles in on goal and Whitlinger covers up. 29 seconds now left to go in the period. Faceoff in the zone. Bobcats trying to get it out of the faceoff circle. Eventually comes to Borgfeld, back for Roessler. And Roessler, her pass. Nice job there to get knocked down in the neutral zone by Gross. A couple players now meeting in front of the penalty boxes. Fritz Ward trying to get it into the zone. Maybe one last rush. She wants to hurry. Roessler loses an edge as she fires this one into the zone. Borgfeld has it. Trying to play it across. Knocked down on the play is Brackett. And that's going to be a delayed penalty on Penn State. But the horn will sound, and that will do it for the first period of play. So the Bobcats are going to start off the second period with a full two-minute power play. We're going to take a quick break for commercials, then come right back with your first intermission report. You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
Way up on a hill in Hamden, there's an arena unlike any other in college sports, where college basketball is played at the highest level, where threes fall like rain and tomahawk dunks are an official stat, where picks find their roles, gives their goes, alleys their oops. This is the den of the Quinnipiac Bobcats, where the men's and women's teams polish their moves for the big dance. Get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Quinnipiac Basketball, live from the TD Bank Sports Center. There's no place like it in sports. Way up on a hill in Hamden, there's an arena. Way up on a hill in Hamden, there's an arena unlike any other in college sports, where college basketball is played at the highest level, where threes fall like rain and tomahawk dunks are an official stat, where picks find their roles, gives their goes, alleys their oops. This is the den of the Quinnipiac Bobcats, where the men's and women's teams polish their moves for the big dance. Get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Quinnipiac Basketball, live from the TD Bank Sports Center. There's no place like it in sports.
And get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. The Bobcats are making some noise this year. Are you? Yeah! Game on!
The all-new Bobcat Shop and Simplify Gift Shop by Campus Customs is now open just down the road at 1010 Sherman Avenue. Officially licensed Bobcat apparel and souvenirs in hundreds of styles, also featuring unique Simplify gift items like candy, jewelry, gourmet popcorn, apparel, and much more. Group screen printing and embroidery orders are also available and produced on the premises with low minimums and quick turnaround time. Visit our website at www.thebobcatshop.com.
Ray and Mike's Deli, the deli destination for Quinnipiac Athletics. Come and try the new Quick Witch, named for Hamden's own Jonathan Quick. Also the fan favorites, the irresistible Mac Daddy and Steak and Cheese. Come in before or after the game, located at 3030 Whitney Ave. Cue cards are accepted.
Hey Bobcat fans, follow us on Twitter and Facebook for daily updates, reminders, and more from the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, the online home for your favorite Quinnipiac sports.
This is Jack McDonald, Director of Athletics at Quinnipiac University. On behalf of all of our student-athletes, coaches, and parents, we are very grateful to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network for broadcasting all our games all over the world to our Bobcat fans. Thank you, QBSN.
I'm Matthias Gauss, and you're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network, the exclusive home of Quinnipiac Athletics. Make sure you stop by at our website at theqbsn.com.
You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network, the official flagship station for volleyball, field hockey, rugby, and men's and women's soccer.
Hey Bobcat fans, don't forget to go to www.theqbsn.com for live broadcasts, game stories, pictures, and more. TheQBSN.com offers you everything you need to know about the Bobcat teams you know and love. Again, go to TheQBSN.com, the online home for your favorite Quinnipiac sports.
You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network. Check us out at theqbsn.com for game recaps, previews, feature articles, and so much more. Your internet home for all things Quinnipiac athletics, theqbsn.com.
Hey, Quinnipiac Bobcat fans. This is Billy Mecca from the Bobcat Sports Network. Please join us this season at the TD Bank Sports Center for some excellent men's and women's basketball and hockey games. The TD Bank Sports Center is the best facility in college athletics.
Back on the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, Rob Samber, the producer here today. Some out-of-town scores in ECAC women's hockey. Clarkson is up on Syracuse 1-0 in the first period at Clarkson. Northeastern is beating RPI 1-0 at RPI. And Boston University and Union are tied 1-1 at Union. Games that are supposed to be starting a little later. St. Lawrence at Boston College and Colgate at UConn. Pete?
All right, thanks, Rob. Field producer Rob Siamba stepping in there for some out-of-town scores. We're going to bring back Nick Dench as we've just been handed the first intermission stats here for the first period. Officially, Quinnipiac out shooting the Penn State Nittany Lions 22-3. Quinnipiac 0-2 on the power play, but the second power play has yet to happen as it's going to start with the full 2 minutes in the start of the second period. Chelsea Layden not really getting that much work in that period, so going to remain on the bench in terms of comments for her so far. But on the other end of things, between the pipes, Celine Whitlinger is certainly a story for Penn State in that first period, as she's the reason why Penn State and Quinnipiac are still scoreless. Dench, what did you see out of her that you liked?
Everything. She was in the right position. She was quick getting across her crease when she needed to on that shot off Dark Angelo's stick that rebounded out to Brown. That was an open net, and she got across the crease very easily. Quick across the crease again on that tic-tac-toe play over to Morgan Fritz-Ward. She got a glove to tip it off to the side. So, I mean, she's really done everything. She's seeing through the screen. She's getting down, covering her five-hole up, defending against any tips. This Bobcats team can't seem to find a way to beat her right now. And you got to think, if Penn State gets a goal before Quinnipiac, it's going to really swing the tides over to Penn State. And Penn State's going to have a lot of trouble maybe losing this game off the way that Whitlinger's playing right now.
Indeed. And certainly, you said, Nick, one of the things that Penn State wanted to focus on pretty much seemed overnight was their defense not allowing the Quinnipiac players to get those shots in low and even those deflection shots. We saw many of the Bobcats' goals last night coming off of deflections, and this afternoon Penn State not being shy about going down and blocking shots, which has pretty much been one of the reasons why the Bobcats and Penn State Lions, Nittany Lions, still remain scoreless after the first period. But as we've said in our pregame, Penn State, very young program, only second year of Division I hockey. And Dench, if you look at the record for this team from last year, trying to look throughout in my notes, they were 7-26-2 last year, but 12 of those 26 games, which were the losses, came by two goals or less, and then they had a 1-6-2 record in games decided by less than one goal. And this is a team that is very young. They're mostly comprised of freshmen and sophomores. They only have three seniors. So do you see this team as maybe taking the next step this year, maybe not making a national tournament appearance or being any threat to win their respective conference, but further down the road, with being such a young team, they're finally starting to get their legs underneath them as a Division I program? Is this program really going to start becoming competitive in the very near future?
Yeah, they're definitely taking the right strides to do that. They're still looking to improve on last year's goals per game, which is only 1.67, so that explains why they were losing by two or less goals. They could hold the teams to three goals, but they couldn't score more than one usually. So it's a team that's looking to improve on that. If they can get that, I mean, Shannon Yoxheimer and Sarah Nielsen really looking forward for this team. Even Hannah Owenshell for this Nittany Lions team. They're showing progress already for this program. Two sophomores and a freshman, very strong offensively. They're scoring goals. Nielsen's getting her assists. She already has four on the season in three games. So this is a Nittany Lions team that's looking to turn in the right direction. This is only their second year in Division I hockey, so you got to think that they're taking the right strides early on in their program existence.
And, of course, Quinnipiac is a program as well, not without their fresh number of freshmen as well. Looking at the lineup right now, out of the players starting today for the Bobcats, Emma Woods, Megan Turner, Danielle Marmer, and Mika Nervik, Emma Greco, and Taryn Baumgard, all the freshmen who are in the lineup today for the Bobcats. Marmer and Nervik have not seen ice time yet today. They did play a couple of minutes last night towards the end of the game to keep their legs fresh. But, Dan, you look at this lineup. Emma Woods coming in, starting on a line with Nicole Connery and Kelly Babstock, of course, filling in for Nicole Costa, who is still out with a lower body injury. And you look at a defense, Taryn Baumgart and Emma Greco, they've really plugged the holes nicely left by defenders such as Felicia Viewag and, of course, the former captain, Regan Bolton. Coach Rick Steele, you talk about chemistry, and I think looking at this lineup with these freshmen in it, it's really safe to say that the Bobcats indeed have started off things here on a positive note.
Yeah, absolutely. Emma Woods had the game-winning goal and the insurance goal in St. Cloud in that 3-1 comeback victory last weekend, and Dark Angelo, you didn't mention, but she's new. So you can consider her a freshman almost with her experience with this team. She's got two goals. Turner had a goal and an assist yesterday. And, I mean, this team has looked really good. Baumgart's had a few good opportunities today. They've been blocked by Penn State, but I think as she starts to progress, something that she's going to realize, even in this game, if they can make the adjustment early, she's winding up for that slap shot, and the defender's just going down. So if she can learn, take that fake slap shot, bring it over a little bit, she might have a clean shot, maybe to get a tip or just beat Whitlinger clean. So this is a team, another young team like Penn State, that they're looking to make the right strides, especially with all the older leadership on this team.
All right, so that'll about bring us to about 4 minutes and 30 seconds before the second period starts. We're going to take another quick commercial break and come right back with keys to the second period and a look at what Penn State needs to do in order to get the first one here against the Bobcats and kill off the penalty to start the second period. You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
Saturday night is hockey night here on theqbsn.com. Tune in at the conclusion of every Saturday men's or women's hockey broadcast for Hockey Night in Hamden. Join QBSN's finest hockey broadcasters, writers, and analysts as they break down the weekend that was Quinnipiac ice hockey. Discussions, debate, arguments, and the occasional five for fisticuffs, all in a one-hour program live at theqbsn.com. Want something debated during the program? Well, email us at hockeynightinhamden@gmail.com or tweet at HamdenHKYNight. When overtime just isn't enough, we've got your extra hockey. So join us at theqbsn.com Saturdays following the last hockey broadcast for Hockey Night in Hamden, your exclusive Quinnipiac ice hockey talk show.
From the outside, the TD Bank Sports Center screams excitement. Inside, it's even louder. It's another season of hard-hitting Quinnipiac ice hockey and red-hot basketball, side by side in one of college sports' most amazing venues for fans. Check the schedule and get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. The Bobcats are making some noise this year. Are you? Yeah! Game on!
The all-new Bobcat Shop and Simplify Gift Shop by Campus Customs is now open just down the road at 1010 Sherman Avenue. Officially licensed Bobcat apparel and souvenirs in hundreds of styles, also featuring unique Simplify gift items like candy, jewelry, gourmet popcorn, apparel, and much more. Group screen printing and embroidery orders are also available and produced on the premises with low minimums and quick turnaround time. Visit our website at www.thebobcatshop.com.
Ray and Mike's Deli, the deli destination for Quinnipiac athletics. Come and try the new Quick Witch, named for Hamden's own Jonathan Quick. Also the fan favorites, the irresistible Mac Daddy and Steak and Cheese. Come in before or after the game, located at 3030 Whitney Ave. Cue cards are accepted.
Hey Bobcat fans, follow us on Twitter and Facebook for daily updates, reminders, and more from the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, the online home for your favorite Quinnipiac sports.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network and Quinnipiac Women's Ice Hockey. We're after one period of play here at the High Point Solutions Arena in Quinnipiac, and the Penn State Nittany Lions are scoreless after one period of play, but Quinnipiac will be starting off the second period with a full 2 minutes of power play time from a late penalty from Yoxheimer for hitting from behind on Olivia Brackett, waiting for teams to take to the ice. The Bobcats wearing their home golds today. They will be skating from our left to right, and the Penn State Nittany Lions in their gorgeous road blues will be skating from our right to left. Pretty good crowd on hand today. A lot of Penn State fans tailgating in the parking lot, as well as the Quinnipiac fans. So 3-0 for a team, Nick, that's only in their second year of Division I existence. For women's hockey, not the most popular sport in the world, with Penn State having a football game this weekend as well. To travel and watch this team play, seeing the tailgate, I think we were walking here to the bank saying, you know what, that's something pretty neat to see.
Yeah, and it's not an hour drive here either. This is a 7-8 hour drive from Penn State to get over here. So it's great to see that they already have fans backing them, and just to be completely honest, it looks like they have the same amount of fans backing them as Quinnipiac does. Quinnipiac's a more established program. So, but Penn State really getting fans early on in their existence, that can only help them.
All right, so the teams are at center ice. Coach Rick Steele opting to go for the first power play unit of Babstock, Connery, Roosler, Woods, and Baumgard. Horn will sound. 20 minutes on the board. Waiting for the referee to drop the puck at center ice. He does. Babstock kicks it out. One by Quinnipiac. Back for Woods. Woods plays it high off the glass. Getting there first is Wilkie. Trying to play it around. Roosler keeps it in. To the blue line for Baumgard. Baumgard trying to go for Connery. Can't get that pass in. And her skates. Babstock takes it all the way around the boards. Far side for Woods. Trying to protect. Wilkie takes it. Knocked into the skate there of Seward. But eventually Penn State's able to get the clear down the length of the ice. And due to the shorthanded forecheck there of Emily Lorenzi, Layden is forced to hold it.
Yeah, Layden might have had a little time to actually stand up and pass that out. But opts to take the frozen puck instead, so a defensive zone faceoff for the Bobcats on their power play, something that they need to work on.
Faceoff won by Quinnipiac. Tamberg playing it off the boards for Brown behind Layden. Brown skates it up herself, trying to connect there with D'Arcangelo, trying to play it up. Turner, though, was offside, so Quinnipiac, 1:18 left to go on their power play, still not a lot of offensive zone pressure as the delayed offsides call.
Second offside called on Turner early on in this game as the Bobcats can't figure out who's taking the faceoff.
Faceoff won by D'Arcangelo. Back for Tamberg, playing it up for Brown. Brown has to deal with the puck sliding off her stick, trying to work it up for D'Arcangelo. Maybe a bit of a miscommunication as Bowman takes it now for Penn State, shorthanded, trying to play it off the boards and out. Indeed, she does. Tamberg knocks it down at center ice. Back into the zone is Brown for Quinnipiac. Brown to the blue line for Tamberg. Across far side, trying to get it back is Tamberg. Tamberg opts to take the shot. That gets deflected from D'Arcangelo just wide. Turner has it now far side. Back to the blue line for Tamberg. Tamberg back near side for Brown. Brown's shot just goes through the crease. Nobody able to get a tip on it. Back Turner. Back for Tamberg at the blue line. Tamberg for Brown. She whiffs on the shot. Couldn't get anything on it. And Penn State gets the clear all the way down. 26 left to go on the Quinnipiac power play, their second of the afternoon. They're 0-1 so far. 18:20 left to go in the second period. 2 minutes in here, still scoreless. Ruessler plays it up for Babstock. Babstock into the zone. That puck rolled right off her stick as well. Back to the blue line for Ruessler. Across for Baumgart. Baumgart here for Connor. He gets the shot. Trickles in. Save by Whitlinger. Still in the slot. Eventually Penn State gets the clear. 2-1, and that'll do it. So Bobcats can't get anything going on their second man advantage of the afternoon. Good kill there by Penn State. Team's back to 5-on-5. Nice job there by Gross to get it away from Woods. Eventually it's played back up for Woods in the neutral zone, trying to play it up for Babstock. Another pass in the skates. So Babstock can't get anything going with that one. As Penn State has it, trying to go connect here with DeSourcy. Nice pin job along the boards there, not availing Collin to get anything going. Far side and then far corner for Pardoski. Pardoski met there by D'Arcangelo. All the way around the boards. Wilkie gets a stick on it, trying to get it back for DeSourcy. And Collin is there trying to work it up for Brown. Brown pins DeSourcy to the boards. Collin coming to her aid. Wilkie now getting in the fray as well. Wilkie trying to get it high off the glass, and she just flips it out of the zone. So that'll be a nice souvenir for one of the lucky fans in the crowd. But the faceoff will stay in the Penn State zone.
Penn State doing a good job once again getting in front of the shots. One of them actually almost backfired, hitting off the stick of Brown, tipped off a Penn State defender, and almost beat Whitlinger five-hole.
Fritz Ward centering feet here, goes off the outside of the cage, and that one's taken away by the stick of Whitlinger. Back to the point here, Tamberg trying to outstretch, keep that one in, trying to play it up for Brackett. Brackett, no-look pass, trying to get around. As Nielsen has it, she sticks it away, out of the zone. Tamberg there. Couple players in front of the Bobcats bench of escaping with it is Nielsen. He looks at her options. Nice job and nice patience to get that one backhander in the zone and go for the line change. West puts on the brakes, trying to play it off the boards for Tamberg. Tamberg circling around now behind her own net. Nice job there to work it up to Fritz Ward, trying to connect with Brackett. Brackett's going to try and skate this into the zone. Can't get a clean stick on it. Going hard into the boards there along with Yonke. Nice job here by Babstock. Take that one off the stick of Lorenzi. And Penn State opts to keep this one away from Babstock. But nice job there. Connery couldn't get it. Now's your chance here for Penn State. Skating into the zone. Shot just goes wide from the stick of Hohenschel. Babstock has it. No look feed there into the neutral zone. Just taken by Bateman. Fired back into the Bobcats' end. Baumgart trying to get there first. A couple players pinned now behind Layden. Puck's just lying there. Ruessler opts to take it in. Try to play it all the way around the boards. Woods can't get it around Rasmussen. A couple of players still meeting up. Ruessler trying to use her long reach to try and get it. Nice job there by Woods. Quick moves of the hands to get it back for Ruessler. Ruessler gets it up for Woods. Hard pass there. Had to contend with it. Now it's Babstock. Babstock trying to wait for some troops for reinforcements from the bench. And she can't get it. Nice defensive play from Seward to get it away. Collin can't keep it in the zone. Rasmussen. But loses it to Greco, who plays it now for Wignall. Wignall back up for Brown. Nice job there to get around. Brown into the zone. She takes the shot right into the crest of Celine Whitlinger. 15-16 left to go in the second period. Still no score.
Holcroft, the one with the odd man or the breakaway for Penn State. Great back check by Ruessler to get over there and force a quick shot that went wide of the net.
Collin has it. Back to the blue line for Wignall. Wignall trying to get back for D'Arcangelo. She can't get anything on it. Nice job there by Collin to keep it in far side. Collin trying to get a cycle going. Eventually it's intercepted here by Wilkie. Nice steal though there by Brown. Centering feeder for Collin. Backhander. Save. Rebound. Score! On the doorstep. Bobcats banging away at it. They lead 1-0 as Nicole Brown puts it home for the Bobcats. They lead 1-0 with 14:58 left to go in the second period.
Nicole Brown doing a great job there, both defensively and offensively, stealing the puck away in the corner, bringing it up on that goal line, throwing it across to Collin, who put on a deep, got it far enough off the right pad of Whitlinger to get a rebound over to the diving Brown to put that in the back of the net. Bobcats finally capitalize on a rebound.
So the Bobcats get their first of the afternoon. Penn State here looking for a response shift. This one trickles out, trying to get a full stick on that, or an even shot was Yonke, but it just trickled right off her blade as West has it for Quinnipiac. West trying to get up here for Babstock. Nice pass. Babstock, a 2-on-1 for the Bobcats. Babstock into the zone, shoots, just goes past the glove of Whitlinger. Another chance here for Babstock out in front. Nice chance there. She couldn't get a full chance on it. Nice protection job there from the Penn State defense, and Whitlinger pouncing on that puck, not allowing Babstock to get a second chance at it.
Babstock looking to increase that Bobcats lead to two very quickly, finds a seam up the middle. Good opportunity, just couldn't hit the net. Not like her to do that, and gets the second opportunity. Great poke check by Whitlinger to get that away from Babstock.
Borfeld has it, trying to work it back to the blue line. Shot here by Roessler, saved by Whitlinger. Back to the blue line again now for Baumgart. Here's Roessler yet again. Roessler, another shot on goal. Rebound! That one just trickles past the open net. Gaping chance there for the Bobcats, but they couldn't put it home. And now it seems that first goal has opened the floodgates for the Bobcats, as they're feeling it now, really taking it to the Nittany Lions. This one cleared all the way around. Nice job there by Fritz Ward to keep. Trying to dance around a couple of players. Wignall's going to keep it. Wignall trying to go into the far corner, but it will be called back on an offsides against the Bobcats.
Wignall slipping up a little bit, dropping back to make sure there's no Penn State breakaway. Puck slipped into the middle. She's lost an edge just a little bit, trying to keep that puck in. Puck very barely slides over the blue line.
Face-off won by Quinnipiac. Greco looking to clear it in, but nice job there by Weaver at her own blue line to just knock it down and clear it back down to the Bobcats' end. Wignall gets there first, puts on the brakes, trying to work it back up for Brown, trying to go far side for D'Arcangelo. D'Arcangelo using her long reach to try and get it. Nice job she does. Centering feet here, Colin out the doorstep. Couldn't put it home. Now it's Greco. Greco trying to connect with Colin. Pardoski gets there first. She has to contend with the forecheck of D'Arcangelo. As the puck trickles to the blue line, Greco has it. Her shot gets deflected by Penn State. Chance here. A couple of Penn State players collide into each other. And Pardoski has it, trying to clear it. That one can't be held by Greco, as West is out to circle in the neutral zone. Play for Babstock, fresh off the bench. Nice shot there by Rasmussen to poke it away. Now it's Woods. One of the many freshmen for this Bobcats team. Woods in on the forecheck, trying to collide there. Babstock does collide with Penn State player. Now it's back for Tamberg at the blue line. Tamberg has a slap shot, stick away there by Whitlinger. Babstock gets to it first, back to the blue line for Tamberg. Tamberg trying to get a sidestep move, work it back down low in for Connery. Connery watched there by the good defense of Yonke. Yonke is on the puck, but escaping with it now is Woods. Back to the blue line for West, but she fell. It's going to be poked around now. Could be a chance, but nice defensive play there by Tamberg to check Hohenschel off the puck. Tamberg has it for the Bobcats. Opts to skate out on her own into the neutral zone, and she's just going to clear it into the zone. Bobcats go for the full line change. 12:06 left to go in the second period. Bobcats on the board. They lead 1-0 thanks to the Nicole Brown goal. Roessler, nice couple of opportunities there to prevent Penn State from cutting through the neutral zone. Still trying to keep it. Eventually touch up with Fritz Ward. Nice chance here by Fritz Ward to poke this one away. Just goes in front of Whitlinger. Penn State all the way around the boards. Roessler is at the blue line, trying to keep it in. Fritz Ward and Borgfeldt now joining the fray, but this one eventually cleared out by Yoxheimer. And Quinnipiac will clear this one back in far corner. Getting there first is Ryle, trying to go back across for Seward. Colin centering feed, nobody in particular. Colin has it now, though. Colin into the zone, shoots. Good save there by Whitlinger. Nice move there, trying to get it as Hohenschel up for Yoxheimer. Yoxheimer has it. Her shot gets deflected. D'Arcangelo trying to protect that puck for the Bobcats. Into the neutral zone, far side. Has some room. She has to just clear it in. This one slowly sticked away by Whitlinger. A couple players go hard into the boards behind the play. It was D'Arcangelo. Woods still trying to get away with it. D'Arcangelo still on the forecheck, but she's going to go to the bench for a change. Bateman out, playing it around for Yonke. Yoxheimer trying to get it out. Babstock trying to keep it in. Eventually worked up for Bowman. Bowman gets taken down, and that is going to be a delayed whistle for interference on the Bobcats. And Penn State will go to their first power play of the afternoon, heading to the box. It seems is going to be...
not really sure. No one's going to the box right now.
It looks as if Nicole Connery... So Nicole Connery gets called for the interference with 10:45 left to go in the second period. Bobcats with the 1-0 lead, going to try to kill this one off. Penn State, though, looking for a chance here to even things up.
Bobcats showing a lot of energy after that last goal. Still keeping the pressure on Penn State. Penn State needs to look for a way to capitalize on this power play right now.
Penn State on the power play, looks to set things up with the man advantage. Here's Gross. Gross fakes the shot, trying to work it in low. Here's a chance out in front. Stout. Nice defensive play, though, by Roessler to get it away from Yoxheimer. And try to clear out is the Bobcats. Babstock couldn't get a full stick on it. Now it's back for Gross. Had to corral in a hard pass. Chance here. Another deflection shot. Just goes wide. Far side here for Seward. Seward trying to get around Babstock. Back for Seward. Trying to reach back across for Gross. She can't get anything on it. It's Baumgard. And she's going to clear it the length of the ice. Bobcats go for the line change.
Looks like Penn State's looking for those centering tips off a play off Yoxheimer right now in the middle of the ice, trying to find a way to beat late and early in this power play.
Seward opting to go for the backhand or deep into the zone as Tamberg's out there. Nice job to protect that puck. Trying to go up high. Knocked down there by Peterson. Peterson, far corner, has to contend with Tamberg, trying to work it back. Penn State, 50 left to go on the man advantage. Bowman has it. Nice job to skate in the Bobcat zone. Drop it off here at the blue line. Back for Bowman. Bowman looking for the centering feed. Bobcats clogging up the slot. They go back to Peterson. Back to the slot. Nice job. Peterson has it back again to the blue line for Yonke. For Peterson. Nice job there by Wignall to get a tip on it. All attack time here so far for Penn State. Back to the blue line for Bateman. Bateman, wrist shot, saved by Layden. And on the doorstep, Penn State still poking away at it, but she smothers it with 23 left to go on the penalty kill to the Bobcats.
Good cycling from Penn State, finding the open shot. And once they get it in there, they're jamming away at Layden, who kept that rebound a little too close to the middle, able to dive on top of it to freeze it. Dangerous rebound there by Layden.
Faceoff won by Penn State. Back to the blue line for Seward. Seward trying to play it for Yoxheimer. Nice block there by Lindsay West, trying to get it out past Yoxheimer. The pinching job there along the boards by Seward. She can't keep it in. And forced to chase it is Podolski all the way back down. Podolski slows it things down. Trying to play it back for Yoxheimer. Intercepted by D'Arcangelo. D'Arcangelo, nice couple of moves there. Hershock is selected out in front. Team's back to 5-on-5. Penn State now 0-for-1 with the man advantage on the afternoon so far. 8:33 left to go in the second period. Bobcats trying to add on to their 1-0 lead. Wignall has it, trying to get it into the neutral zone. Eventually touched up there. Collins spun around, couldn't get a clean chance at it. Now it's Roessler. Roessler into the zone, showing some nice signs of speed. Roessler has it backhand, or just goes wide. Going to get her own rebound, and she indeed gets taken down with a trip on Penn State. So the Bobcats now will head to the man advantage. Tripping is the call with 8:13 left to go in the second period. And heading to the box is defenseman Paige Yonke.
Roessler with a good burst of speed at the blue line, cutting through the entire Penn State defense. And sometimes it's a good thing when a defender steps up into the play, and she single-handedly drew that penalty and almost had a goal.
Indeed, Sydney Roessler with the Bobby Orr-like rush eventually draws the penalty, and the Bobcats go back to the man advantage, 0-for-2 so far on the afternoon. Nicole Brown plays it up for Turner. Turner now into the zone for the Bobcats, circles around, trying to get it back to the blue line for Tamberg. Tamberg slows it down, back across for Turner. Turner, cross-ice feed here for Brown. Brown shot, chance here on the doorstep. D'Arcangelo poking away at it, and eventually covering it is Whitlinger. Puck eventually trickled after the whistle was blown. Fritz Ward saying to the official, maybe that whistle was a bit too early. Nonetheless, 1:34 left to go on the man advantage for the Bobcats. They go with the first unit now.
Whitlinger maybe a little surprised that puck got through off the stick of Brown. A little late on it. Kept the rebound close. D'Arcangelo poking away at it, unable to capitalize.
Nice win by Babstock to Connery. Now it's Baumgard at the blue line. Baumgard back for Roessler. Roessler takes the slap shot. Just goes past the glove of Whitlinger. Roessler gets it back from Babstock. Across for Baumgard. Looks at her options. Back for Roessler. Roessler fakes the shot. Goes across ice for Connery. Connery has to contend with some good defense there by Penn State. Babstock has it back for Roessler. Roessler, her shot blocked away by Whitlinger. Woods has it far side, trying to find Babstock in the near corner. Babstock centering feeder for Connery on the doorstep. Couldn't get a clean stick on it. Roessler going back across here for Woods. 52 left to go on the man advantage to Quinnipiac. Roessler goes for Connery. Stave made there by Whitlinger. Woods has it. Has to contend there with Bowman. Eventually Penn State gets a clear.
Good tie-up by Bowman off the stick of Woods. If she doesn't do that, Bobcats still have the puck inside the offensive zone. Penn State able to get a switch.
30 left to go on the power play to the Bobcats. 6:40 left to go in the second period. Turner has it for Quinnipiac, trying to connect with Fritz Ward. Couldn't get a clean chance at it. Nice job here by Quinnipiac, trying to keep it, but better chance there by Wilkie to get it out for Penn State. Tamberg trying to play it up for Turner. Another hard pass Turner had trouble dealing with. Now it's Fritz Ward into the zone. Fritz Ward waiting for some reinforcements at the blue line. Tamberg has it, shoots. This one saved by Whitlinger. And Penn State does get the clear. 1 second left, and that does it. So Quinnipiac now 0 for 3 on the afternoon with the man advantage. Nice chances here by Penn State. Here's Turner, though. Turner has it, shoots. Rebound here for Turner into the slot. And this one just trickles to the side. Nielsen has it for Penn State, trying to clear it. Nice job there to keep it at the blue line by Lindsey West. Now it's Woods trying to get the puck away from Wilkie. Off the bench, Babstock centering for Connery. Connery back to the blue line across. Here's Greco. Greco takes opts to take the shot. That one knocked down by Rasmussen, but the Bobcats still keep it in the zone. Connery now coming to the aid, eventually trying to work for Babstock. Babstock trying to get it back for Connery. Taken down on the play. Still a nice couple of chances here by Babstock. A couple of players still tumbling over each other in the zone. This one cleared all the way down by Penn State. Getting there first is Greco, so we'll be icing against the Nittany Lions with 5:20 left to go in the period.
Another hard forecheck by the Bobcats, leading to an icing by Penn State, who has had trouble all day getting out of their zone, and it's led to a few good opportunities for the Bobcats off these icings.
Faceoff to the right of Celine Whitlinger. Collin in there against Nielsen. Nielsen wins it back, but Brown quickly on the boards trying to get that puck away. He has pinning Jill Holdcroft. Nielsen and Wilkie trying to get that one out. Collin there as well. Eventually it's worked to Pardoski. All the way around the boards, kept in by Roosler. Roosler shot wide, trying to be tipped purposely by Collin. Eventually back for Baumgard to Roosler. Roosler, slap shot, nice block by Eric Erasmussen for Penn State. And Baumgard is forced to chase all the way back down to her own zone. Roosler has it. Wrist shot in on goal. And Whitlinger is going to corral this one in with 4:43 left to go. Faceoff going to be in the Nittany Lions' end.
Roosler taking a few more shots than she did last period. Not afraid to unload that slap shot that is one of the harder ones on the team. That one so hard it actually rebounded two blue lines back.
Fritz Ward trying to play it far side. Ryle gets it, trying to play it out. This one high into the zone, knocked down by Quinnipiac. Turner has it, Turner shoots, and this one just trickles past the open net. Lindsey West trying to get the cycle for Turner. Turner trying to protect that puck. Indeed she does, back into the zone, knifed down by Borgfeld. Fritz Ward there trying to be knocked off the puck. Nice protection here by the Bobcats on this shift. Borgfeld now into the fray. Pins Ryle to the boards, Fritz Ward now joining. Player still trying to knock away at it. Referee yelling at the players to let it loose. Fritz Ward, weak backhander, but this will be intercepted by the Bobcats. Woods all the way around. Borgfeld there behind. Up for Fritz Ward who shoots. This one calmly sticked away by Whitlinger. Woods can't get that one cleanly. Fritz Ward now coming to help her out. This one worked up for Bowman. And that one can't be kept in by Lindsey West. Fires it back in. And this one knifed down in the neutral zone by Lindsey West again. For Babstock. Babstock slap shot off the skate there of Ryle. And now it's Connery fresh off the bench. Connery trying to get the forecheck going. 3:24 left to go in the second period. And falling on it is a Penn State player. Referee opting to go for the quick whistle. And that will bring the faceoff still in the Nittany Lions end.
Puck getting tied up on the board has killed a lot of time throughout this game, and the referees are getting a little tired of it. So a quick whistle there, keep the play going.
Faceoff won by Penn State. This one high up in the air. Can't be knocked down by Greco. Here's a chance here for Joxheimer. Joxheimer into the zone. Can't get around Wignall. Great defensive play there, and Greco cleans up the mess. Kept in at the blue line, though. This one in on goal, and Layden's going to cover it up with 3:07 left to go. Quinnipiac holding on to the 1-0 lead.
Wignall once again with a very strong back check. That time having to race back to catch the speedy Joxheimer, who actually got an opportunity to show off her speed that time. And Wignall able to get her stick in and tie her up. Greco able to clear it out.
Couple players trying to fight for that puck in the faceoff circle. Eventually Penn State will escape with it. Nielsen has it. Into the slot. This one taken away by Baumgard. Nice steal there, though, by Yoxheimer, but Baumgart takes it right back. Trying to play it up for Fritz Ward, but it's Yoxheimer again for Penn State. Yoxheimer into the zone, backhander, loud rebound there off the pads of Layden, and eventually Brackett will get it. Trying to go into the neutral zone here for Turner. And Turner will skate it into the zone. Go for the chip off the boards, go around the defense of Penn State. Fritz Ward is there, trying to play it for Brackett. And eventually going all the way around with this one is Lorenzi. Lorenzi trying to get around Tamberg, both in a foot race. Nice job there by Tamberg to close her off with the puck. Penn State keeps this one in, though. They have a couple of players in the crease. Back to the blue line, though. Wrist shot here by Wilkie gets blocked by Brackett and eventually trickles out of the zone. Pardoski playing it up here for Yoxheimer. She's going to go for the high dump in. Layden plays this one off her pads again. This one, nobody could touch it as it's cleared down the length of the ice. Icing against the Bobcats. 1:56 left to go in the second period.
Penn State giving Quinnipiac a taste of their own medicine for the time being. Strong offensive attack right now. First one they've had probably all game where they've been able to keep it inside the zone and cycle it through. So Penn State looking to build with 2 minutes left in the period.
Faceoff won by the Bobcats, but taken away by Penn State. Nice defensive play there by Turner to take that pass away and get it in further, get the Bobcats the line change, but is going to be whistle on the play, delayed offsides on the Bobcats.
Bobcats jumping the gun a little bit, knowing that they have the opportunity to have an odd man rush, going a little too fast, puck slow to cross the blue line.
Face off at center ice, Bowman and Babstock. Quinnipiac takes it, Wignall trying to play it off the boards. Nice step here to pinch it up for Babstock. Babstock trying to get it across for Connery, but maybe going a little too fast, couldn't put the brakes on soon enough. Now Penn State's turn to go the other way. They just chip it into the Bobcats end. Wignall gets there first. Has to watch out, though, from the forecheck. Back to the point for Ryle, trying to get it back across for Hohenschel. Hohenschel and Wignall now battling along the boards. Hohenschel, nice job protecting, trying to look for the open man. Peterson's there, but eventually comes to Woods, and she works it back for Connery. Another hard pass. Connery did get a tip on it. Seaward, though, gets it. Circles around in her own zone, trying to play it up. Eventually comes to Peterson. Peterson pinned in front of her own bench by Collin, escaping with its Hohenschel. But Greco knocking her off the puck. Wignall takes it. Final minute of play in the second period. Nice job there, though, by Collin to corral that one in. Collin into the zone, trying to get a centering for D'Arcangelo. Nice stick lift there by Seward. D'Arcangelo trying to go back. Seward intercepts. Has it, trying to get it for Brown. Brown in the slot, shoots. Another deflected shot by Penn State. Now it's Collin in the slot. And her shot right onto the crest by Whitlinger with 30 seconds left to go in the second period.
Whitlinger doing a good job reading what her defense is giving. Her defense gives Collin a shot from the slot, the high slot, but taking away the passing lane, so Whitlinger able to get in a good position and not get beat on that one.
Faceoff here is Yoxheimer, has it in the zone, knifed away though by the Bobcats. Here's Borgfeld into the zone, her backhander trying to find Fritz Ward in the slot. Turner trying to get their far side first. 16 left to go in the period. Back for Roessler at the blue line. Roessler walks in, fakes, chasing after her own puck. That one shot off the blocker of Whitlinger, trying to take this one in is Gross. She's met there by Fritz Ward. 5 seconds left to go. Quinnipiac, if they hurry, Borgfeld has it behind. But the horn will sound. So two periods in the books here at the High Point Solutions Arena. And the Quinnipiac Bobcats go into the locker room with the 1-0 lead over the Penn State Nittany Lions. We're going to take a quick commercial break. Come right back with your second intermission report. You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network.
This is Jack McDonald, Director of Athletics at Quinnipiac University. On behalf of all of our student-athletes, coaches, and parents, we are very grateful to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network for broadcasting all our games all over the world to our Bobcat fans. Thank you, QBSN.
I'm Matthias Gauss, and you're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network, the exclusive home of Quinnipiac Athletics. Make sure you stop by at our website at theqbsn.com.
You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network, the official flagship station for volleyball, field hockey, rugby, and men's and women's soccer.
Hey Bobcat fans, don't forget to go to www.theqbsn.com
for live broadcasts, game stories, pictures, and more. TheQBSN.com offers you everything you need to know about the Bobcat teams you know and love. Again, go to TheQBSN.com, the online home for your favorite Quinnipiac sports.
You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network. Check us out at theqbsn.com for game recaps, previews, feature articles, and so much more. Your internet home for all things Quinnipiac athletics, theqbsn.com.
Hey, Quinnipiac Bobcat fans. This is Billy Mecca from the Bobcat Sports Network. Please join us this season at the TD Bank Sports Center for some excellent men's and women's basketball and ice hockey games. The TD Bank Sports Center is the best facility in college athletics as it features family-friendly seating, prices, dates, and times. Please call area code 203-582-3905 or visit QuinnipiacBobcats.com to order your tickets now. Go Bobcats! Peace!
Saturday night is hockey night here on theqbsn.com. Tune in at the conclusion of every Saturday men's or women's hockey broadcast for Hockey Night in Hamden. Join QBSN's finest hockey broadcasters, writers, and analysts as they break down the weekend that was Quinnipiac ice hockey. Discussions, debate, arguments, and the occasional five for fisticuffs all in a one-hour program live at theqbsn.com. Want something debated during the program? Well, email us at hockeynightinhamden@gmail.com or tweet at HamdenHKYNight. When overtime just isn't enough, we've got your extra hockey. So join us at theqbsn.com Saturdays following the last hockey broadcast for Hockey Night in Hamden, your exclusive Quinnipiac ice hockey talk show.
From the outside, the TD Bank Sports Center screams excitement. Inside, it's even louder. It's another season of hard-hitting Quinnipiac ice hockey and red-hot basketball, side by side in one of college sports' most amazing venues for fans. Check the schedule and get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. The Bobcats are making some noise this year. Are you? Yeah. Game on.
The all-new Bobcat Shop and Simplify Gift Shop by Campus Customs is now open just down the road at 1010 Sherman Avenue. Officially licensed Bobcat apparel and souvenirs in hundreds of styles, also featuring unique Simplify gift items like candy, jewelry, gourmet popcorn, apparel, and much more. Group screen printing and embroidery orders are also available and produced on the premises with low minimums and quick turnaround time. Visit our website at www.thebobcatshop.com.
Ray and Mike's Deli, the deli destination for Quinnipiac athletics. Come and try the new Quickwich named for Hamden's own Jonathan Quick. Also the fan favorites, the irresistible Mac Daddy and Steak and Cheese. Come in before or after the game, located at 3030 Whitney Ave. Cue cards are accepted.
Hey Bobcat fans, follow us on Twitter and Facebook for daily updates, reminders, and more from the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, the online home for your favorite Quinnipiac sports.
This is Jack McDonald, Director of Athletics at Quinnipiac University. On behalf of all of our student-athletes, coaches, and parents, we are very grateful to the Quinnipiac...
Rob Siamber back here on the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network with some out-of-town scores. Start of the third period at Union. Boston University is tied with Union 1-1. Northeastern leading RPI 1-0 at RPI. Clarkson beating Syracuse 2-0 in the middle of the second period at Clarkson. Final at UConn, 3-2. UConn women's hockey beats Colgate. And Boston College in the third period right now, defeating St. Lawrence 5-2. Pete, back to you.
Scores. Now we're going to bring back Nick Dench. We're after two periods of play here at the High Point Solutions Arena, and the Quinnipiac Bobcats have the 1-0 lead over the Penn State Nittany Lions. Quick scoring summary for you folks listening in at home. At the 5:02 mark of the second period, Nicole Brown for the assist from Amanda Collin. Originally Cheyenne D'Arcangelo did have an assist, but it was deemed that she did not have an assist, so they took it away.
Plain and simple.
Officially, Quinnipiac outshooting the Nittany Lions 46-9. So again, the story of this afternoon for both teams has been goaltending. Again, Chelsea Lading not getting that much work in, but certainly on the other end, Celine Wittlinger so far 45 saves on the afternoon, only yielding the one goal. There's pretty much a scrum in front of the net with Brown banging home the rebound. Teams still scoreless with the man advantage. Quinnipiac 0-3 and the Nittany Lions 0-1. Teams neither have power play or penalty kill opportunities to start the third, so it's going to be 5-on-5 action to start. So, Dench, Quinnipiac now, we saw they really turned it on towards the end of the second period yesterday and came out in the third flying. And for Penn State, they really played a solid game yesterday all around. A very deceiving 5-1 defeat, you could say, if that. But now they only trail Quinnipiac 1-0. If you're the coaching staff of Penn State, you say, you know what, we lost this team 5-1 yesterday, but we're only down 1-0, and our goalie has pretty much kept us in this one. What could we do to try and help her out and try to get one on the board?
They're going to have to get a clean breakout at some point during the third period. They've iced the puck a lot. They're just kind of tossing it out and hoping that somebody with speed like Joxheimer can catch up to it before a Bobcats defender does. So, I mean, they're not getting out of their zone cleanly at all. The Bobcats forecheck is really beating them down hard, and you gotta find a way to get outside of your zone and then transition into the offensive zone to get a sustained offensive attack. They had one with about 3 minutes left in the period, but they weren't able to capitalize, got a couple shots on late, and other than that, they really haven't had anything to show for the first 40 minutes of play.
Indeed, and now just talk a little bit about the men's ice hockey team. They started their regular season off in Alaska last night as they dropped their first game of the season 3-1 to Alaska Anchorage Seawolves. You know, a couple of people in the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network had the feed going. And the team, of course, you don't want to make excuses, but travel may have been a certain factor, as the game aired at 12 o'clock midnight on the Eastern Seaboard, so, and didn't end till around 3 o'clock in the morning. So certainly everybody over here was tired and waking up this morning, and the loss really didn't help things. But again, Michael Gartig now is going to be the starter. No more Eric Hartzell, and a lot of freshmen for that Bobcats team. So certainly they head back now into Alaska Fairbanks tonight for an 8:07 puck drop, Eastern time, and they look to even up their series in Alaska at one apiece and head home into the regular season next weekend against what could have been the number one ranked UMass Lowell, but again, they were defeated last night by Sacred Heart, an absolute stunner of an upset early on here, early goings for college hockey. So again, the team that's hot is the team that usually comes away with the win. But now just about 5 minutes and 48 seconds left to go between the teams come back out for the third period. Again, all you folks tuning in at home, Quinnipiac wearing their home golds and the Penn State Nittany Lions wearing their road blues. As Sacred Heart University is now losing 6-0 to RPI. So maybe last night they went into that game with a little bit of a cockiness to their game and were brought right back down to earth. But nonetheless, now just about 5:18 left to go now. We'll take another quick commercial break here on the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network and come right back with you.
Follow us on Twitter.
Keys to the third period. You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network.
More from the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, the online home for your favorite Quinnipiac sports.
This is Jack McDonald, Director of Athletics at Quinnipiac University. On behalf of all of our student athletes, coaches, and parents, we are very grateful to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network for broadcasting all our games all over the world to our Bobcat fans. Thank you, QBSN.
I'm Matthias Gauss, and you're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network, the exclusive home of Quinnipiac Athletics. Make sure you stop by at our website at theqbsn.com.
You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network, the official flagship station for volleyball, field hockey, rugby, and men's and women's soccer.
Hey Bobcat fans, don't forget to go to www.theqbsn.com for live broadcasts, game stories, pictures, and more. TheQBSN.com offers you everything you need to know about the Bobcat teams you know and love. Again, go to TheQBSN.com, the online home for your favorite Quinnipiac sports.
You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network. Check us out at theqbsn.com for game recaps, previews, feature articles, and so much more. Your internet home for all things Quinnipiac Athletics, theqbsn.com.
Hey, Quinnipiac Bobcat fans. This is Billy Mecca from the Bobcat Sports Network. Please join us this season at the TD Bank Sports Center for some excellent men's and women's basketball and ice hockey games. The TD Bank Sports Center is the best facility in college athletics as it features family-friendly seating, prices, dates, and times. Please call area code 203-582-3905 or visit QuinnipiacBobcats.com to order your tickets now. Go Bobcats! Peace!
Saturday night is hockey night here on theqbsn.com. Tune in at the conclusion of every Saturday men's or women's hockey broadcast for Hockey Night in Hamden. Join QBSN's finest hockey broadcasters, writers, and analysts as they break down the weekend that was Quinnipiac ice hockey. Discussions, debate, arguments, and the occasional five for fisticuffs all in a one-hour program live at theqbsn.com. Want something debated during the program? Well, email us at hockeynightinhamden@gmail.com or tweet at HamdenHKYNight. When overtime just isn't enough, we've got your extra hockey. So join us at
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Third period action about to get underway here at the High Point Solutions Arena at the TD Bank Sports Center here at Quinnipiac University. The Quinnipiac Bobcats have the 1-0 lead over the Penn State Nittany Lions. As we said, this is the first ever weekend series meeting between these two teams. Quinnipiac winning last night by a score of 5-1. They hold the 1-0 lead here so far on the afternoon. No carryover, power play, or penalty minutes. Just waiting for the teams to skate out to the ice. Quinnipiac, wearing their home golds, will be skating from our right to left, and the visiting Nittany Lions and their road blues will be skating from our left to right. As both coaching staffs have reached their bench, the linesmen coming out to the Imperial March theme from Star Wars to signal that they are certainly the bad guys of the afternoon. As the teams now are skating out to take the ice for the third period. So, Nick, if you're Penn State, what do you want to do early on in this third period to try and get one on the board and pretty much tell your team that they're not going to go away quietly?
Like I said in the intermission, just get a clean breakout, win this faceoff even. If they can get a clean faceoff win here and get the puck into the offensive zone, start throwing pucks on net. You can't score if you don't shoot. We saw that last year in the playoffs when Kristen Eklund threw the puck from the oddest angle ever and scored. So, I mean, the key to scoring is putting the puck on net. And if Penn State hasn't been able to do that, only 9 shots to their credit right now, they have to find a way to get this puck on target and try and beat Chelsea Layden somehow.
Indeed. So, Bobcats take center ice. Nittany Lions take center ice. Babstock and Nielsen are in to take the faceoff to start things going for the third period. Puck is dropped. Faceoff is won by Quinnipiac. Babstock working it back here to Baumgart, who works it up for Roessler. And she opts to go for a clear into the zone. Connery is out working it for Babstock. Babstock centering feeder for Connery. A couple players not being able to get clean break on it. Now it's Nielsen for Penn State.
Nielsen trying to chip it around Rusler. She gets her own rebound. Centering feet here, trying to get it to the blue line, but nobody was there. Penn State was going for the change. This one guided away off of goal from Layden. Babstock is out to get it. She opts to go off the boards and into the Lions zone. Line change for the Bobcats. Peterson loses this one in her skates as Brown has it, trying to play it back up for Collin. This one sticked away by Whitlinger. All the way around the boards. Nobody there at home. Try to keep it in. Eventually, Bobcats do. DeAngelo has it. She has some room to skate in, and her shot gets deflected just along the crease. Back to the point for Tamberg. Her shot gets deflected. Penn State still trying to get it out. Eventually, touch up here. A nice chance there for Hohenschell off the breakout pass. Would have had a clean breakaway if she was able to corral that one in. DeAngelo now has it, playing it for Borgfeld. Borgfeld backhanding it, and then in a foot race now with Seward. Seward gets it, chips it around for Ryle. Getting there is Fritz Ward as well. She gets taken down, loses her stick. Eventually it comes back up to Holdcroft. Holdcroft opts to let Ryle take it. This one fired back down. Getting there first is Wignall, so we'll be icing against Penn State. Just about 2 minutes into the third period here. Quinnipiac still up 1-0.
Another icing from Penn State. That's got to be at least 7 in this game. And once again, they haven't been able to break out cleanly. They're throwing it up and hoping one of their players can skate onto it before a Bobcat beats them to the faceoff dot.
Connery playing it from her knee. Shot here by Woods. She scores! Pass from Connery finds Woods. She chips it over the glove of Whitlinger and gives the Bobcats the 2-0 lead. 18-17 left to go in the third period.
Emma Woods with her third goal on the season, now leading the team in that category once again. And this freshman is a pure scorer, and she's pairing up perfectly right now with this Connery-Babstock line. So Bobcats once again finding a way to get their freshmen and new players involved early on in the season.
Yep, the fluttering shot from Woods just went over the glove of Whitlinger into the back of the net. And the Bobcats now have the 2-0 lead, but they're looking for more, and the hill just became that much steeper for the Penn State Nittany Lions. A couple players get taken down. Far side shot here, intercepted by Wignall. Wignall looking at her options for a lane to pass. Eventually trying to be worked up to Brown. Trying to leave it off, and firing it back into the zone is Pardoski. Greco's to take it for the Bobcats. She's going to clear it into the zone, get the line change. Pardoski is out, trying to play it. Intercepted there, trying to keep it in by Turner. Is losing an edge was Tamberg. Eventually it comes worked out here to Gross. She works it all the way down to the Bobcats end. Slowed down by Layden, worked up here by Borgfeld. Borgfeld trying to get up for Fritz Ward. Nice job by Penn State to poke that one away. Eventually Turner. She puts on the brakes. Bobcats going back to that first line of Woods, Babstock, and Connery. Babstock trying to get this one chipped into the Bobcats' end. Laying it out. Plays it off for Baumgard. Baumgard trying to work it back for Roosler. Roosler off the boards, trying to go for Connery. Her backhander trying to get up with Babstock. Eventually she does. Could be a two-on-one break here for the Bobcats. Babstock into the zone. Puts on the brakes. Trying to find Connery in the slot. But Connery, again, just that much ahead of the play. Couldn't get anything on it. Babstock yet again tries to go. She's going to play it all the way around the boards. Dropping it off. Yonke has it for Penn State. Trying to play it up for Peterson. And Peterson plays it high. She gets checked. No call on the play, though. Wignall has it. Trying to get around the forecheck of the Lions. Now it's Roosler looking to break out. Roosler far side. Skates it in. Looks at her options. Centering feet here for Brown. Couldn't get a clean break on it. Collin now in the corner with Brown, trying to get around with it. Seward. Seward for Penn State, trying to go across for Ryle, trying to touch it up here. Down out of the zone, and a foot race now is Greco and Bowman. Greco trying to protect that puck. Bowman trying to poke it away. Wignall circles around late and looks at her options. Nice job there to get it from the forecheck of Holdcroft. Borgfeld can't do anything with that one as it just cleared back into the far side. Collin is out, trying to settle it down into the neutral zone. She opts to just dump this one back down. Fritz Ward crashes into the near corner. Coming to her aid now is Borgfeld. And Borgfeld gets checked hard into the boards from behind. Whistle was called. A delayed penalty call here against Penn State as Borgfeld was taken hard into the boards. Heading to the box is Jordan Pardoski. So the Bobcats go back to the man advantage. They're 0-3 on the afternoon. Prime opportunity, though, to try and put one of some of the final nails in the coffin here for Penn State.
Not a smart penalty there from Pardoski. Puck just tied up on the boards, creeps out just a little bit, and she checks Borgfeld from behind. Not a smart penalty. Puck was actually in the Penn State possession, so something that she's going to have to cut down on going forward in the season.
Baumgard trying to play it across for Connery real quick. Connery's shot just sails over the net, able to be kept in by Baumgard. Baumgard back to the blue line for Roosler, trying to get it for Woods, trying to go cross-ice feed to connect with Connery. Connery still has it, protecting, trying to go for the lane. Babstock has to deal with the bouncing puck, playing it back for Woods. Woods to the blue line for Baumgard, for Roosler. Roosler fakes the shot, nice job there. Still has it, trying to get it for Connery. Connery shoots. This one gets deflected into the paraphernalia of Paige Yonke, and eventually it drops out. And the faceoff will stay in the Penn State zone.
Yonke selling out to block that shot. And the Bobcats are starting to learn that if you wind up for a slap shot, this Penn State team is going to drop down and try to block the shot before you go back for the shot. Bobcats starting to fake their shots a little more.
Turner has it for the Bobcats. Back to the blue line for Tamberg. Fakes the shot, trying to find Brown. Brown trying to find Fritz Ward in the slot. This one cleared out by Penn State and all the way down. 1:07 left to go on the power play to the Bobcats. 14:32 left to go in the third period. Bobcats up 2-0. Bobcats are onside. Brown skates it in. This shot, nice save there. And Tamberg can't keep it in on the blue line. Cleared down the length of the ice again by Penn State. Tamberg picks up the puck. Couple of moves here trying to get Brown in front of the Bobcats bench. Brown trying to play it up here. Eventually touches up with D'Arcangelo trying to find Turner. Turner spins with it. Drops it off for Baumgard into the zone. D'Arcangelo using her long reach to get it. Still has it back to the blue line for Roosler to Baumgard. Baumgard trying to find D'Arcangelo. She scores! Nice cross-ice feed from Baumgart, finds the transfer student, and the Bobcats now up 3-0 on the power play goal.
D'Arcangelo with her third goal on the season, and Tara Baumgart registering her first career point as a Bobcat on a great feed and an awesome tip from D'Arcangelo there. That's something Penn State was trying to do on their power play. They were unable to get those tips on target. And D'Arcangelo able to get that one on target, beat the glove of Whitlinger.
So the Bobcats get their first power play goal of the afternoon. Their third goal overall from junior transfer student Cheyenne D'Arcangelo, who's been stellar so far in her Bobcats career. As this one's brought around for Brackett, can't play that one off the boards. Fritz Ward has to deal with it. Slows things down behind Layden. Looks for the outlet, trying to touch up there with Turner. No icing call on the Bobcats. Pardoski trying to clear this one out. Eventually it'll be taken at center ice. Work back up for Woods. Woods back into the zone. Her shot gets blocked there by the Penn State defense. This one brought back into the zone. Couple players still trying to get away at it. West has it. West trying to chip it up for Connery. Connery has a couple players in the slot. Nice move here by Connery. Shoots! And a save there by Whitlinger. Connery's been trying to do that all afternoon, but Whitlinger is there yet again to shut the door.
Connery probably one of the more creative, short, sure-handed players on this Bobcats team. She's not afraid to pull off a couple moves, and she did it there. Just unable to get it back on her forehand and get enough power behind it to beat Whitlinger. Backhands it right into the crest on Whitlinger's jersey.
And we're going to have a timeout called here, I do believe, by Penn State to try and diagram maybe some plays as they're down 3-0 now at 12:52 left to go in the third period. Unofficially, Bobcats outshooting the Nittany Lions 49-9. Coach Rick Seely must be proud of his squad so far in the afternoon as they were scoreless after the first period of play, and as we saw last night, the Bobcats getting even stronger as the game has gone along.
Yeah, and the Bobcats really going with what Coach Rick Seely and his coaching staff have told them in the intermission, and really doing a great job. They've scored 2 goals on 4 shots this period, so they're making the most of their opportunities now, and something that this team's really going to have to work towards, especially with the strength of the ECAC this year. You're going to have to register with everything your coaching staff says to make adjustments and get better as the game goes on, and they're proving they can do that early on in the season.
So the horn will sound. Both teams back into the Penn State defensive zone. D'Arcangelo, the most recent goal scorer for the Bobcats, in on the faceoff, going up against Lorenzi. Penn State winning it, trying to play it high off the glass and all the way around. Eventually they do clear it down. This one knifed into defensive zone by DeSourcy. And Penn State now trying to get some offensive pressure going here against the Bobcats. Centering feed here, a nice chance, but the Quinnipiac players clogging the slot. Penn State not being able to get anything going on that one. Roessler fires a pass in the neutral zone for Brown. Brown, nice sidestep move, just clears this one back down. And now it's Mika Nervik getting her first ice time of the afternoon, one of the freshman forwards for this Bobcat squad. Greco trying to play this one off her skate. This one fired, goes again off a Quinnipiac player in the form of Brackett. And now it's Wignall in the near corner. Wignall slowing things down, has to contend with Jill Holdcroft, who puts a nice crunch into her along the boards. This one rung all the way around for Bowman. Eventually getting there is Greco, trying to contend with Bowman. Now Peterson now joins the fray. And Brackett still trying to get this one out eventually. And eventually she will do it. And the Bobcats might have numbers if they hurry. Fritz Ward into the zone, far side, looking for the centering feed. Puts the brakes on. Waiting for players at the blue line. It's West. West shoots. Save made by Whitlinger. Good look, though, for West coming right off the bench and opting to take that shot.
West may not have wanted to put that shot there. Bateman getting her stick in and altering where West's follow-through went, so probably pushing that puck off a little further left than West wanted it. Good scoring opportunity off the pass from with Fritz Ward.
Here's Connery again showing the soft hand she has, eventually losing the puck, though. Babstock first there, far side. Woods eventually will find it. Shoots it on goal. Chance here, shot! Saved by Whitlinger, a couple players still banging away at it, and Connery puts it up top shelf. And the Bobcats now lead 4-0, 11:22 left to go in the third period.
Another strong forecheck from Kelly Babstock, something she's become very good at over her time here at Quinnipiac, finding the cross-ice pass to Connery. Connery getting stonewalled once again by Whitlinger, who made a great sliding save the first time, just unable to recover and get back up off the seat of her pants, and Connery roofs it for her second goal of the year.
Here comes Penn State, though. Nice play there by Roessler, taking down the player. It will be tripping. Roessler not happy with the call, saying she got the puck first before she took down Yoxheimer, but nevertheless, once the official makes his call, you're pretty much not going to get away with that one, so Roessler will sit for 2 minutes. Penn State back to the power play. Unable to get anything going with the man advantage so far in the afternoon. Bobcats penalty kill has been stellar so far.
This may be what Penn State needs early on in the season. Get their offensive confidence back up with a power play goal right here.
Greco trying to play it off the boards. Turner trying to clear this one all the way down. Popped up high into the air, eventually not out. Chance here for Penn State now on the doorstep. Couple players there meeting up. And great defensive play there, diving to try and stop it was Greco. Here's Bordowski now. Gross trying to get it back to Bordowski. Nice couple of blocks here by the Quinnipiac defense, showing Penn State they can do it too. Wignall in the near corner, trying to get a clean stick on it, trying to clear it down the length of the ice. Indeed she does. 1:20 left to go on the man advantage to Penn State. 10:32 left to go in the third period. Quinnipiac now up 4-0. Bordowski trying to get it all the way around into the zone. Layden is out to slow it down. West gets there first, and she clears it down the length of the ice as it goes through the skates of Yonke. Yonke gets her own rebound off the boards, playing it up here for Bateman. A nice job there, shorthanded by D'Arcangelo to poke it away. Now circling with it is Yonke, trying to play it up for Holdcroft. West is out to try and get it. No icing on the play. Tamberg has it. Slap shot all the way around as Collin touches up with it and clears it down the length of the ice.
Bobcats seems being very aggressive on this penalty kill, getting up on the forecheck and not allowing Penn State to set up an offense like they have been all game.
Penn State still having troubles getting into the Bobcats zone. Shorthanded chance. Connery now trying to keep it hemmed in. to the Nittany Lions end. Yonke slows things down behind our goalie. Drops it off for Peterson. Peterson trying to go across for Bateman. Bateman's backhander in the zone. That gets intercepted by Wignall and cleared out. Could have been a chance there, but now might he be a chance here for Babstock. Babstock shorthanded into the zone. Has to deal with puck. She couldn't get anything on. She goes hard into the boards after. But she's up and okay. And that will do it for the power play to Penn State. So another good kill there by the Bobcats. Wignall kicking this one off her skate. Drops it for Turner. Turner into the zone. Centering feed here. Still has it. Her backhand centering feed just goes through the blue paint. Borgfeld's out now trying to get this one. Fritz Ward back to the blue line for West. West settles it down across for Tamberg. Tamberg's wrist shot. Save made by Whitlinger. Borgfeld trying to go back around for Turner. All the way. West gets their first shot. Sticked away by Whitlinger. Couple players meeting along the boards just to the right of the goal. Turner's in with the fray. Trying to kick it loose. Eventually does come loose. Trying to get there first is Fritz Ward as she gets taken down. Trying to pass the puck up. And eventually it's Bowman. Bowman trying to get this one. That gets intercepted. This one cleared high off the boards. Nervik fresh off the bench plays it and clears it back down. Brown gets there for the Bobcats. She's pinned to the boards now by Ryle. D'Arcangelo trying to see what side that puck's going to come out on. Nervik eventually scribs it to Roessler. Another shot goes off the outside of the cage. This one all the way around getting there for Penn State is Weaver. D'Arcangelo still banging away at it. Eventually getting it is Ryle. Almost intercepted there by D'Arcangelo. And eventually it's worked up. Penn State, nice pass here to Rasmussen. Rasmussen finds this one just roll right off her stick. Play here, another shot right into the glove of Layden. And she will calmly hold it with 7:38 left to go. Quinnipiac 4, Penn State 0.
Layden being safe on that one, probably going wide of the net. But in the middle of a line change, you want to get your team out cleanly. So she takes the frozen puck and lets the Bobcats get a free, clean line change.
Bateman, strong backhander into the corner. Babstock gets there first. Babstock trying to get the outlet pass. Shot here just goes past the blocker of Layden. Another chance here for the Bobcats to try and clear it cleanly. Greco can't. Connery is there trying to get it out. Eventually they do. DeSourcy trying to play it across for Lorenzi. Lorenzi met there off the glove of Babstock. Still at the blue line for the Bobcats. Nobody able to get a clean stick on it. And eventually Wignall will take. Nice job by Wignall to split the forecheck. She still has it, trying to play it up. Fritz Ward, or check that, Marmer couldn't outstretch for it. Wignall gloves this one down. Wignall in on the forecheck now, waiting for players. Nice job to protect all the way back around into the slot. Wignall taking the shot, but that gets blocked. Trying to take it, slow things down is Brackett, trying to play it back for Fritz Ward. Fritz Ward pinned to the boards. Brackett now coming to help her out. 6:30 left to go in the third period. Escaping with it is Nielsen, watched by Fritz Ward. Slowing things down. Turner trying to escape with it. Fritz Ward from her knees getting the pass to Lindsay West. She goes to play it off the boards deeper into the zone. Delayed penalty call here on the Bobcats for interference. And heading to the box is Olivia Brackett.
And Brackett just getting a little too tied up with the Penn State defender. And Bobcats had another scoring opportunity there. So with 6:15 left in the third period, Brackett taking an interference penalty that probably didn't need to be taken.
Couple players still meeting up in the faceoff circle, which has happened today as well. Back to the blue line. Peterson has it. Back to the blue line for Seward. Peterson and her Seward playing catch. Now it's back down low for Nielsen. Nielsen centering feet here, nobody home to try and slam it on the doorstep. So now it's Peterson, can't get anything on that pass, trying to go back around. Nice intercept by Roessler, and she's going to fire it down the length of the ice. Bobcats go for the quick line change for the penalty kill. 1:28 left to go on the man advantage to Penn State. Nice drive here by Bateman to get around Babstock. Bateman still trying to get into the zone as now Wignall comes to the log at her. Wignall, nice job here, but work it out in front. And Layden will come out and pounce on that bouncing puck and get the freeze with 1:16 left to go on the power play to the Lions.
Bobcats still forcing Penn State to be a little
rushed on their decisions offensively. Aggressive defense throughout the entire game, not allowing Penn State to do much offensively.
Another tie up in the faceoff circle. Penn State escaping with it. Joxheimer centering feet here, high up in the air, trying to glove it down on the other end of things was Hohenschel, but eventually the Bobcats get it out of the zone. Here's Seward back in, gets it around West. Tamberg is there first. Tamberg trying to go for the strong clear, eventually trying to get it around Pardoski. Turner taking a couple of whacks at it, trying to get it away. Bladen is out, slow it down. No look pass here, West going for Tamberg. Tamberg tied up a little bit, trying to work it up for Turner, but now it's Gross. Nice defensive play there by Turner. Back here into the slot, Joxheimer, and then good block and then clear out of the zone by Fritz Ward.
Fritz Ward with a good read there, seeing Joxheimer with her stick up like she wanted a shot in the middle of the slot, and Fritz Ward sliding over when the pass came, blocking the shot, getting it out.
Another good defensive play there by Roosler, and the Bobcats simply just chipped this one out back into the neutral zone as well. Back in around the boards, Layden out to play it. Drops it for Roosler. Nice job there to deflect with Collin back down the length of the ice, all the way deep into the Penn State end. D'Arcangelo intercepts this one, looks for the centering feed. Kaz Collin. Her shot just gets deflected wide. Teams back to 5-on-5. Another strong kill for the Bobcats. Roosler trying to contend, not this one. Baumgart out to play it, trying to get around Holdcroft. Baumgart and Holdcroft now into the near corner. Comes loose, trying to be played there. Shot, Layden's up, she catches it, and another hold with 3:49 left to go in the third period. Quinnipiac up 4-0.
Layden once again seeing that the Bobcats want a line change and just taking the freeze and letting them get a clean line change. Under 4 minutes now remaining in the game.
Faceoff won by Penn State. Nice keep at the blue line by Wilkie. All the way around, Greco is there with Weaver. Greco battling with it now. Coming to her aid is Welch. Welch circling with it, trying to go in the slot. Goes off the glove of Layden. Back to the blue line for Wilkie. Wilkie's shot gets deflected, and it's Connery now. Connery into the zone, trying to put a nice move on, but just rolls away from her. Connery back here, trying to connect with Babstock to the blue line for Wignall. Wignall fakes the shot, trying to go back for Connery. Connery centering feed, nobody there. Back to the blue line. Greco slap shot. This one gets deflected wide. Wignall is there pinching, trying to keep it in. Back around the boards. Bobcats going for the partial line change. Woods pinched to the boards there. Tamberg fresh off the bench, trying to keep it in. Babstock has it, and she's just going to lift this one up, and the Bobcats will complete that line change. Fritz Ward able to keep it into the zone. This one cleared out. Tamberg is there first in the neutral zone, playing it back for West. West is out, playing it off the boards, trying to connect with Fritz Ward. Indeed, she does. Fritz Ward centering for Borgfeldt, still poking away at it, but just sliding under the pad there of Whitlinger. She held it to the ice with 2:37 left to go in the third.
Whitlinger doing a good job holding her ground there, even with the net crash from Borgfeldt, and just a good job keeping her pad down and keeping her mind in the game, even though this is a 4-0 game with 3 goals scored in the third period.
Another mix-up of players in the faceoff circle. Penn State escapes with it. Roosler thought twice about pinching, but now could have a trouble here as Bowman has it. Bowman into the zone, but nice backup play there by Baumgart, trying to play it up for Collin now. Collin gets spun down to the ice. Baumgart has it. Circles around with it. This one poked through her skates by Hohenschel. Baumgart escapes with it, though, trying to play it up for Brown. Brown has it now. Has Collin streaking towards the net. Feed here for Collin, just outside of her reach. Collin still has it, trying to play it for Brown. Brown pinned to the boards now by Bowman. Babstock fresh off the bench, playing that puck out of her skates. Babstock, nice protection of the puck into the zone. Couldn't get all that backhander, though. Trying to go back to the blue line. Kept in by Greco. Greco, again, back around the boards. Seward's there. She plays it around. Kept in by Wignall. Wignall loses an edge, trying to feed it towards the front of the net. Nervik circles with it. Still finding the lane to pass. Wignall's back for it, trying to play it. Babstock plays it off her skate. Centering feed here. Connery gets her stick lifted. Connery now using her legs, trying to get it. Back for Nervik. Nervik pinned to the boards by Ryle. And the puck squibs loose. Ryle now Can't get anything on it. Nervik, nice play there. Connery now still coming to raid. Long shift here for Connery. Fresh off the bench is Fritz Ward. Nice stutter step move. Get it into the zone. Fritz Ward now has it. Shoots. And a left pad save by Whitlinger with 1 minute and 1 second left to go in the third period.
Fritz Ward either looking for a rebound towards Lindsey West there or maybe even trying to hit West on the back post. Just the outstretched pad of Whitlinger keeping that puck in her possession.
Last minute play in the third period. Bobcats keeping the play down in the Penn State zone. Turner still chasing after it along the boards in the near corner. Escaping with it is Yonke, but Borgfeld takes it. Borgfeld, no look, drop pass, trying to find a Bobcat in behind. Turner still keeping it pinned along the boards. Fritz Ward back to West of the blue line. West shot goes wide. Trying to connect it with the tip maybe for Borgfeld. Nice play there by Tamberg to prevent Joxheimer from getting anything on it. And Tamberg clearing it. Joxheimer finding this one eventually behind her. Fritz Ward yet again for the Bobcats. Fritz Ward slowing it down. Trying to go around for Turner. She was tangled up a bit at the side of the goal. Not able to get it all the way. Baumgart playing it back for Fritz Ward. Backhands it into the zone. 7 seconds left to go in the period. Penn State still trying to get it out of their zone. And the final horn will sound as D'Arcangelo touches it. So the Quinnipiac Bobcats complete the weekend series sweep of the Penn State Nittany Lions as they win in this one 4-0. Chelsea Layden mobbed by her team as she comes off the bench. Layden's second shutout of the young season. We're going to take a quick commercial break, come right back with your full game recap, and get head coach Rick Seely and maybe a couple players up here in the press box as well get their thoughts on the game. So don't go anywhere, folks. You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
Saturday night is hockey night here on theqbsn.com. Tune in at the conclusion of every Saturday men's or women's hockey broadcast for Hockey Night in Hamden. Join QBSN's finest hockey broadcasters, writers, and analysts as they break down the weekend that was Quinnipiac ice hockey. Discussions, debate, arguments, and the occasional five for fisticuffs all in a one-hour program live at theqbsn.com. Want something debated during the program? Well, email us at hockeynightinhamden@gmail.com or tweet at HamdenHKYNight. But overtime just isn't enough. We've got your extra hockey. So join us at theqbsn.com Saturdays following the last hockey broadcast for Hockey Night in Hamden, your exclusive Quinnipiac ice hockey talk show.
From the outside, the TD Bank Sports Center screams excitement. Inside, it's even louder. It's another season of hard-hitting Quinnipiac ice hockey and red-hot basketball, side-by-side in one of college sports' most amazing venues for fans. Check the schedule and get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. The Bobcats are making some noise this year. Are you? Yeah. Game on.
The all-new Bobcat Shop and Simplify Gift Shop by Campus Customs is now open just down the road at 1010 Sherman Avenue. Officially licensed Bobcat apparel and souvenirs in hundreds of styles, also featuring unique Simplify gift items like candy, jewelry, gourmet popcorn, apparel, and much more. Group screen printing and embroidery orders are also available and produced on the premises with low minimums and quick turnaround time. Visit our website at www.thebobcatshop.com.
Ray and Mike's Deli, the deli destination for Quinnipiac athletics. Come and try the new Quickwich, named for Hamden's own Jonathan Quick. Also the fan favorites, the irresistible Mac Daddy and Steak and Cheese. Come in before or after the game, located at 3030 Whitney Ave. Cue cards are accepted.
Hey Bobcat fans, follow us on Twitter and Facebook for daily updates, reminders, and more from the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, the online home for your favorite Quinnipiac sports.
This is Jack McDonald, Director of Athletics at Quinnipiac University. On behalf of all of our student-athletes, coaches, and parents, we are very grateful to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network for broadcasting all our games all over the world to our Bobcat fans. Thank you, QBSN.
I'm Matthias Gauss, and you're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, the exclusive home of Quinnipiac Athletics. Make sure you stop by at our website at theqbsn.com.
You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, the official flagship station for volleyball, field hockey, rugby, and men's and women's soccer.
Hey Bobcat fans, don't forget to go to www.theqbsn.com for live broadcasts, game stories, pictures, and more. TheQBSN.com offers you everything you need to know about the Bobcat teams you know and love. Again, go to TheQBSN.com, the online home for your favorite Quinnipiac sports.
You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network. Check us out at theqbsn.com for game recaps, previews, feature articles, and so much more. Your internet home for all things Quinnipiac athletics, theqbsn.com.
Hey, Quinnipiac Bobcat fans. This is Billy Mecca from the Bobcat Sports Network. Please join us this season at the TD Bank Sports Center for some excellent men's and women's basketball and ice hockey games. The TD Bank Sports Center is the best facility in college athletics as it features family-friendly seating, prices, dates, and times. Please call area code 203-582-3905 or visit QuinnipiacBobcats.com to order your tickets now. Go Bobcats! Peace!
Saturday night is hockey night here on theqbsn.com. Tune in at the conclusion of every Saturday men's or women's hockey broadcast for Hockey Night in Hamden. Join QBSN's finest hockey broadcasters, writers, and analysts as they break down the weekend that was Quinnipiac ice hockey. Discussions, debate, arguments, and the occasional five for fisticuffs all in a one-hour program live at theqbsn.com. Want something debated during the program? Well, email us at hockeynightinhamden@gmail.com or tweet at
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the High Point Solutions Arena at the TD Bank Sports Center. Quinnipiac Bobcats have defeated the Penn State Nittany Lions 4-0 and take the series sweep, winning 5-1 last night and again 4-1 this afternoon. It was 0-0 after the first period, and then Quinnipiac finally started to find their legs, and that's pretty much the same story as last night. As the game wore on, Quinnipiac became the better team.
Yeah, Quinnipiac, a more well-conditioned team. I mean, it helps when you have this hill that you can run up for conditioning. So, but Penn State, really, I mean, they're not in the same league as Quinnipiac yet. They're definitely good for the fact that they're a second-year program. Strong showing from them defensively. Offensively, they still need to work out the kinks of the whole breakout situation and not icing the puck so much. Bobcats getting just one goal off seven or eight icings from Penn State today, so they're doing a good job defensively, good job blocking shots, just unable to beat the Bobcats' strong forecheck and in the neutral zone. But you got to look at the two goaltenders this week, and Celine Whitlinger and Nicole Panicha. They both played very well, and these 4-0, 5-1 wins are not on the goaltenders at all. When you see 100-plus shots between the two games, that's a lot of shots for a goaltender to keep out. So the Bobcats definitely outplaying the Nittany Lions this past weekend.
And certainly Chelsea Layden getting both starts as well. Coach Rick Seely alluding to the fact and she started both St. Cloud games and she started both this game, both the games this weekend. Again, for confidence, she pretty much had to sit and wait for Victoria Vigilante to graduate and move on. Do you feel like, Nick, that she's finally starting to get that confidence underneath her where she's saying, you know what, if this team needs me, you know, to back them up, and, you know, I can certainly do that.
Yeah, I mean, two shutouts already, that's huge for her confidence. Even if it is a 12-save shutout, it's a shutout nonetheless. And Penn State had some good opportunities. They were doing a good job tipping the puck in front on the power plays, so she's definitely showing that she's poised to be in net
and she's doing a good job just staying within herself and not trying to do anything too extreme. She's a different play style than Vigilante. Vigilante, a very fast and aggressive goaltender. Layden knows her play style, and she didn't go outside of that when she was playing behind Vigilante these last couple of years.
All right, as we're having head coach Rick Seely walking towards the press box now, going to get his thoughts on the game, the games today, and the games this weekend as a whole, and maybe his opportunity to give us an opinion about what he's expecting from next weekend heading up to Maine. Once again, we're going to be joined by head coach Rick Seely. Coach, first off, congrats on the win.
Thanks, Pete.
So what were some of the things today that you saw your team that you liked out of them?
I liked our energy better today. I thought we built on yesterday's game, which was a good game, but I thought each period we got stronger and stronger throughout the game.
And, of course, you alluded to the fact that Chelsea Layden needed to get some good confidence wins underneath her belt. What have you liked out of her so far?
I mean, she just looks solid. I don't think she was really tested today. I thought our back check was great and our defensive coverage was pretty good, but she's been a rock so far.
And the freshman coming up big again, once again for this team, Emma Woods scoring today, playing on that top line. What have you seen out of her that you've liked?
Well, she's great around the net. You know, it's been a tough adjustment, this level four, and that's fine. It is for a lot of freshmen. But when you can be scoring goals while you're learning, that's fantastic.
And next weekend, going up to the road trip to Maine, what were some of the things you want to see out of your team to work on?
Just keep building on the good things we're doing. You know, early in this game, I think we were handling the puck a little too much. We had moments of that yesterday. Just, you know, when we move the puck and are skating, we're a pretty solid team, and we just want to keep building on that.
And, of course, Cheyenne D'Arcangelo continuing to be a big factor for your team. Have you expected anything less out of her so far?
No. And I think she's going to get better. She continues to learn the system, and, you know, she's a good student of the game. I thought her goal was fantastic. That was a great pass shot from Taryn Baumgart. So it's real exciting to have three lines that can roll like this.
All right, Coach. Well, again, congrats on the win, both wins, and good luck next weekend.
Thanks, Pete. Have a good night.
All right, you too. I'm going to bring back on Nick Dench to fill some of the time as well before Chelsea Layden comes up here, gets some of her thoughts on the game as well. So, Nick, again, Coach Rick Seely said last night one of the main things they wanted to focus on was cutting down on the length of their shifts. We certainly saw tonight that pretty much any time the puck was not in any dangerous zone, the Bobcats were going for that line change. And, again, it's a learning experience for this freshman to realize their limits of what they can do so far here as a freshman.
Yeah, and, I mean, the freshmen are learning their limits very quickly, and they're learning where they need to be very quickly in this system. Emma Woods has three goals, tied for the team lead with the newcomer Cheyenne D'Arcangelo, and Megan Turner's looked real good in her first couple of games. Taryn Baumgart getting her first career point today on a great pass, as Coach mentioned, from on the fourth goal to D'Arcangelo. So, I mean, even Emma Greco looks real good out back. She had a great diving play in the crease to keep this a 4-0 game. So, I mean, all the freshmen that are getting significant minutes are stepping up, and they're showing that they're learning this system and they're not afraid to sell out for this team.
Yeah, sellout certainly one thing they're not afraid of. Quinnipiac really blocking shots left and right in today's matchup, so that was certainly one of the positives Coach Rick Seely could take out of the game today as we're still awaiting Chelsea Layden to come up. You know, it takes a lot of time to get all that goalie equipment off, and you know, it's a long walk up here from the locker room. There's a lot of stairs. So we're going to give her a couple more minutes, but we're going to do a quick scoring summary first for all you folks tuning in at home. Second period, 5 minutes and 2 seconds, Nicole Brown from Amanda Collin and Nicole Connery. And then in the third period, just about 1:43, and Emma Woods, again, the freshman from Nicole Connery and Kelly Babstock. Collin only assisting on Brown's goal. And then, of course, in the third period, on the power play, Cheyenne D'Arcangelo from Taryn Baumgart and Sydney Roessler. And then just about 2 minutes later, Nicole Connery from Kelly Babstock and Emma Woods. So, again, the freshman playing a big part in not only today's game but the season so far as a whole. As Quinnipiac tie and win St. Cloud, then they come home, they sweep Penn State. And looking to the schedule now, they head next weekend up to Orono, Maine, and they have a two-game swing against the Maine Black Bears. And then they're on the road for conference play when it starts at Harvard and Dartmouth. So, Getch, if this team could possibly keep rolling here throughout non-conference play heading into that first game at Harvard, we're going to get your thoughts on that as Chelsea Layden now is going to be stepping into the press box. Give Chelsea a minute to catch her breath here. A lot of stairs on the way up here.
Goalie props.
All right, Chelsea. Well, first, congrats on both wins this weekend.
Thank you.
So we know you had to be patient since you've been coming here at Quinnipiac. I had to wait for Victoria Vigilante to graduate. But how have you felt about your game now being the starter for this team so far this season?
You know, I feel like having 17 starts under my belt really helped me get the feeling of playing at this level. And I've had a lot of practice. And if I have Quinnipiac shooting on me every day in the last 2 years, and we've been pretty good. So, you know, I felt pretty prepared coming into this year.
And how difficult is it in a game when you don't see that many shots when one finally decides to come your way and you have to stop it?
You know, it's just like a constant focus. And, my goal this year is just take every single shot. Like, seriously, I can't look too far ahead. And if that's 50 shots a game or if it's 12 shots a game, it's always that next shot that I have to be ready for. And it's my responsibility as a goalie. And, you know, if I only get 12 shots a game, that's totally okay with me.
And, of course, you lose a couple of senior leadership on the defensive side of things in front of you in terms of Felicia Biewig and Regan Bolton. You have a couple of freshmen come in on defense in front of you. What's that been like?
I am so proud of my freshman defense and freshman players all around. But just tonight watching not only our freshmen but everybody block shots, like, I felt like I had five other goalies out there with me. And they've adapted to our culture, and they've blocked more shots than I think any other freshman defense has done in the past.
All right, so you head up now to Maine next weekend for a two-game swing before conference play starts. What are your expectations heading into next weekend?
You know, I feel like if we play like we did tonight and we add to it, like, more detailed, I think we can definitely find success this weekend. I feel like we can find success this weekend if we just play like we have, but continue to get better, of course.
All right, so there it is. Chelsea Layden gets both wins and the shutout today. Congratulations and good luck next weekend.
Thank you very much.
All right. We're going to have Nick Detch head back in. Just, again, final quick scoring summary again. Last goal, Nicole Connery from Kelly Babstock and Emma Wood. So, again, as we said, Nick, freshman playing a huge part in the weekend series against Penn State and heading to next weekend. And then soon after conference play, I think Coach Rick Seeley is really going to finally see what these freshmen can really do once you start playing the Cornells and the Harvards and, you know, the Dartmouths of the ECAC.
Yeah, and, I mean, the freshmen are getting a good non-conference, kind of easing them in almost to college hockey, and I mean, they don't have an easy ECAC weekend to start. They're going to Harvard, which is projected top three, and then at Dartmouth, so it's quite a bus ride up there to Dartmouth as well. So it's not an easy opening weekend, but it's definitely not the hardest opening weekend they could have. So they have to look forward to Maine, prep for those two games, then after that you look to Harvard and Dartmouth. If you look too far, Maine's going to get you once, and that's going to kill your confidence going to Harvard, which is one of the best teams in the ECAC.
All right, so that'll about wrap things up here for the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network. First, we'd like to thank the chairman of the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, Kevin Noonan, as well as the broadcast managers of Zachary Daly and Marty Joseph. We'd also like to thank Director of Athletics for Quinnipiac, Jack McDonald, and, of course, for the players and Coach Rick Seeley coming up here and giving us their comments after the game. So Quinnipiac takes this game 4-0, and the weekend series sweeps the Penn State Nittany Lions. You folks at home can celebrate this one with a soda for our field producer, Rob Siambra, and my color commentator, Nick Dench. I'm Pete Rossi. Don't forget, tune into Hockey Night in Hamden following this broadcast on the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network's Ustream. That's all, folks. We'll catch you next time.